All right, America. We've been telling you about this for a long time. This Jade Helm, it's coming down. It's going down. And if you don't believe it, let me just show you. I'm here at Sam's Club in San Angelo, Texas. And let me show you something. Look at that. Yeah? What do you think about that? Huh? Did you see that? There's trailers here. Look at this. Oh, yeah. Black tarps on a fence. Black tarps on a fence with dumpsters. And there's even some cardboard boxes and chain link. Cardboard, ladies and gentlemen, cardboard boxes and chain link, okay? Black tarps and chain link. I don't understand why people aren't seeing this. Let me show you something else that's a little more sinister, okay? You think, oh, that's just chain link, right? That's just a black tarp. No big deal. Let me show you something else, right? Okay, because Jade Helm's happening where? Mostly in Texas. Look at this. Look at this right here. That says Tex. T-E-X. That's for FEMA to know that this trailer needed to come to Texas. Okay, that's probably got ninjas in there that can take our guns. There could be weapons of some kind of... There's just no telling, okay? Look, you want to... That's not that bad. Maybe that's just a trailer, right? Not a big deal. Let me show you something else. Number three. This is just in San Angelo. Look at this right here. That's Knight Transportation. Does that remind you of anything? Like Knights Templar? Like the guys that used to do all of the sneaky stuff? America, this is happening. You need to get yourself right, America. You need to get it right. If you don't believe that this is going down, come on down here to the Walmart. Go to the Sam's Club. You need to see this. This is happening. Get yourself right, because I tell you what, this is not where you want to be when Jesus comes. Is this where you want to be when Jesus comes back? I don't think so, America. Get it right. This is Chris Martin in San Angelo at Sam's Club, and it's going down. It's going down right now. Get yourself right.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. You are on the air. Tonight, Jade Helm 2015. Joining me tonight are the 2014 gubernatorial candidate, Kathy Glass, U.S. Senator candidate, Rebecca Paddock, and Rob Kinney. What is Jade Helm? Are we being invaded? We're all going to die. I couldn't hear my drop. I'll do that later. Later in the show, Dani Blaze enlightens us on the hypocrisy of Facebook posts and why people who are using online dating are still unsuccessful. And that means yours truly. Your calls at 866-225-5401 or 512-539-0357. Tweet me at @MikeAllen_OTA and hashtag that bad boy armed radio. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network. And you... You're on the air.
Now, I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love.
And now, another deep thought from Brooklyn Express.
So I just finished washing my car. Got the car all detailed up. It just so happens I'm under a tree. So I get in my car, go to pull off, and I crank up the music. And by cranking up the music, freaking bird shits right on my window. I'm thinking to myself, who do I know that has a chainsaw? I could chop that tree down right now. But I had a deep thought. Being a green thumb type of guy I am, I said to myself, you don't gotta do that. Chop down that good tree. You might as well just spray the whole tree with some pesticides so the next time any bird gets up there, it'll just drop dead within seconds. Now that's the right way to do things. That's a good deep thought.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spring. Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
All right, welcome back to the show. As I get our panel lined up, just reminding you, tonight's broadcast is brought to you by Eat24.com. Go to Eat24.com, download their app. You can go put your zip code in from where you're at, and they'll find a food that will deliver to you. And I'm trying to do two things at once. This isn't working well. This isn't working well at all. Go ahead.
Download our app, Eats.
You don't even know what it's called.
It's called Eats24. That was
Eat24.com.
It was a .com. It was a dramatic pause. Eat24.com. Put in your zip code.
Zip code.
Find some food that you like. They'll deliver the food to you. It's like a party in your pants, mm-hmm. or food in your pants, or a food truck in your pants. It has something to do with your pants. That's what you say every time.
It's like a food
Although,
truck in your pants.
Honestly, usually my food situation is I've dropped food on my pants. Eat24.com.
We're not professional, but...
Oh, my goodness.
They'll never forget that.
Joining us now on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, please welcome... 2014 gubernatorial candidate from Texas, Ms. Kathy Glass, and U.S. senatorial candidate from Texas, Ms. Rebecca Paddock. Welcome, ladies.
Hello, Rebecca. Hello, everyone else.
Hello.
Hi, Kathy. Hey, Mike.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Great. Pretty good.
All righty. Well, we've got some stuff going on. I'm going to try to get this other gentleman on. His name is Rob Kinney. He's a radio, it's a TV personality and gunsmith, who we're going to bring him in here on this discussion. What we're going to be talking about is Jade Helm. Have you guys been following this at all, or?
Somewhat.
Mm-hmm. Somewhat?
Yes. Yes, we have. I've been to a meeting and often trying to keep up as best we can.
So what's the deal? I mean, is this... what is this Jade Helm all about? I know what I'm reading online. I think it's all about nothing, personally. But what are your thoughts, Ms. Glass?
Well, I think it's not a routine exercise, but I don't think it's a martial law or confiscation of guns or roundup of dissidents or any of the things you've heard. I went to the meeting in Bastrop, and I just wanted to ask questions of the spokesman, Mark Olastoria. And I thought it was very informative what he had to say. And basically, they're talking about mastering the human domain. That's their logo. That's their objective. And I'm saying, well, why are you coming into Texas to master the human domain? What does that even mean? And Texans don't like it. We don't like what we're hearing. But the suspicions, I think, are far more than what we should conclude is actually going on.
So, did you ever get a straight answer to that?
Well, to the master of the human domain, I think we did get a straight a good enough answer. But it's like, I don't understand. What do you have to gain? What information do you glean from going into Bastrop, Texas, and towns all over Texas, and mastering their domain? What does that mean? Well, I talked with a friend of mine who's been engaged in similar exercises, and he said, well, I went and got, he's been a participant as part of the armed services, and he's been a participant just outside as a civilian. And he said, well, I went in and I got a job in a convenience store, and then the exercise was for them to come and find me based on clues like what bumper sticker I had on my car and things like that. And we engaged. And I thought, okay, well, that doesn't sound very alarming, but neither does it sound very convincing for why this exercise gives them information that they can use and go overseas. What does it matter how they master the Texas human domain, how they infiltrate us and get blend in with us and get feedback from us? How does that translate to anything we legitimately want our military to do?
Well, thank you. That's Ms. Kathy Glass, who ran for governor of Texas last year. Joining us now, Mr. Rob Kinney on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline. He's a gunsmith, retired vet, TV show personality, and owns a gun shop, currently residing... I'm going to let you tell him that. I don't know. Want me to give away, but Mr. Rob Kinney. Rob, what do you think about what Kathy just said about, I mean, she's down here, she's on the ground, she's very involved politically with the state of Texas. I mean, what are your thoughts? What do you think this is all about?
I didn't hear the whole conversation. I kind of got in on the tail end of it, but, you know, I've been following this whole Jade Helm thing, and the major thing, you know, I understand, with 21 years served myself, the importance of training. You know, you got to get them young soldiers out there and get them trained up and get them prepared for, my question is, what? What is this Jade Helm all about? You know, I wish they'd come forward and actually spit it out what they're preparing for. There would be a lot less conspiracy theorists jumping at every little thing and Walmart closings and... You know,
yeah, because I've never seen a Walmart close without another one opening across the street, personally. That's
well,
just me.
I've got some friends that you know, they tell me, you know, we used to work there, and when I walked out the last time, they were clearing off the shelves and putting in cubicles, and it looked like makeshift jail cells. And I was like, my God, you know, give me a picture. Give me some hard evidence that I can post. You know, and well, they couldn't. They, you know, they were having to turn their phones in and everything else going in and out.
Huh.
Another big concern that I have, training damage and loss of life. You know, I was stationed in Germany, and the U.S. did a lot of training off the Army installations, and we caused damage with our tanks and our tracks and our, back then it was Jeeps, and we were responsible for that damage, and some of that damage was even loss of life. And, you know, you start doing away with the Posse Comitatus Act, and you start training within the civilian sector, it just opens up a whole big box of worms, man. You know, somebody's going to get hurt. Guess what? Okay, here's an MRAT going down the road and it swerves off because the soldier's tired as hell and kills a family on vacation. Guess what? You can't sue the federal government, people. Okay, what about all these planes that are now starting to fly around? And you know, what's going to happen when one comes burning and crashing into a mall somewhere? You know, this thing's going to kick off for 90 days. And I'm hearing reports of barns getting blown off, horses getting scared through barbed wire and costing, you know, livestock lives. You know, and this is just the first day.
Well, you know, let me interject. I too, spent some time in Germany overseas. Rob, especially in Germany and Korea. And I will tell you that the money that the United States government paid out in damages, well, here's an example. If say, one of our tanks ran over a cow, the United States government was not only responsible for that cow, but all the cows that that cow would have produced up into three generations, plus the cows that those cows would have produced up into another two generations, plus any milk and cheese and dairy products that were lost from the loss of that cow. So we've actually had,
exactly.
we've had stories of German farmers, you know, they get their sick cows or the ones that ain't really doing too well, and they just kind of, well, sorry, let them out in the night, and the M1 tank grinds them up, and oops, payday. Rebecca, what
yeah,
do you think?
It's sad, but, you know, why all the secrecy?
Yeah,
you
that's...
know, this is supposed to be a transparent, you know, government that we have now, and I'm not seeing it. I'm really not.
Rebecca, do you have anything to add?
Well, I am kind of keeping up with this from a different perspective. I have a lot of contacts in the military, so... I've been working it through that end, find out what's going on and keep up with it where I can. And I think Kathy and Mr. Kinney both have some really good points. This isn't a normal exercise, right? It's being done on privately held land versus publicly held land. So that's a very different thing. And as Mr. Kinney said, doing things on privately held land, it's happened before, right? It happened in Germany. This is just the first time it's happened in the U.S. that we know of, right? It could have happened before and we don't know about it. If it's happened before, I don't know about it. I'm assuming this is the first time. Now, as far as the transparency goes, if I put like a military hat on, and say, I'm doing this exercise, and I'm doing this exercise in the public domain because there's something about the public private domain, because there's something about it that I cannot recreate on publicly owned land. There's got to be a reason for that. Making that reason transparent to American citizens also makes that reason transparent to terrorists and other people. So I can understand where we might not be getting some of the straightest answers or things are not fully explained.
All right, well, joining us here with us, that was Ms. Rebecca Paddock, but joining us is our own talk show host, who you can hear every Monday and Friday night, Mr. Matt Haisley from Straight Talk, who's this kind of stuff is up his alley. Matt, you've had some, well, I tell you what, we're going to go into a break. Can you all stick around for the next segment?
You bet.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and mute up your phones real quick. We're going to run some commercials. When we come back, more discussion with Kathy Glass, Rebecca Paddock, Rob Kinney, and our own Matt Haisley. We'll be right back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
I say good.
You got a light on you?
All right, folks, welcome back to the show. We have live on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, 2014 gubernatorial candidate Kathy Glass, U.S. Senate candidate Rebecca Paddock, Rob Kinney, who is a TV personality and owns a gun shop, and our own Matt Haisley from Straight Talk with Matt Haisley, heard every Monday and Friday night right here on Armed Radio Global. Welcome back to the show, folks. As we left, Matt came on, and he says he has some information concerning the Walmarts. Go ahead, Matt.
Well, can you hear me, Mike?
Yep, we can hear you good.
Okay, good. I'm just checking out. This is a different headset I'm using. So I talked with a master plumber who's been doing plumbing for, 30-plus years, and I asked him, he does all type of inspections and everything on all the plumbing work that's done in any building or anything throughout, for city work. And I asked him, I said, to look this up. And he goes, this doesn't make any sense. He goes, there's no way that a company like Walmart would close down a store. For they do is they cordon off the big old sheets of plywood, and they'll quarter off that area, and they'll build almost a wall, temporary wall inside the store. They'll dig up the floor, reroute the plumbing, do it all while the store is completely open. They never shut down. This Walmart makes $1.8 million in profit an hour. So they're not going to shut down a store or eight stores or five stores, what they did, throughout five different states unless there's a reason. A lot of them say it was union-based, but Walmart will go around that. They don't care. They will... they'll do anything, but to shut down a store completely, it's unheard of almost.
Anybody want to chime in to the new revelations here?
Well, I was watching some information that was sent to me a while back, and it's on YouTube, and he was filming as he approached a Super Walmart that had been closed down in West Virginia, and it had razor wire put around it, on the roof part of it, and it had chain link fence put around the back, and it's on a military style access gate, and I don't know. It's just not making any sense to me. I'm a practical kind of person. I keep both eyes open and ears open and my head on the swivel, and I'm seeing a lot of stuff, and it's just not adding up. Training exercise, really? This has got to be costing billions of dollars to move all these tanks all over the United States, and MRAP, and they can say it's only in the southern states, but I've got photographs that are being sent to me as far up as Indiana. So, is it the local National Guard training, Well, none of the vehicles even have markings painted on the bumpers. So, you know, I'm not really too certain about that either. So, you know, something doesn't smell right to me, and I'm kind of glad you had me on the show today. Maybe somebody else knows something I don't. I mean, please, share it.
Well, people can call in. The 1-800 number is down, but you can call in 512-539-0357 or tweet me at MikeAllen_OTA and hashtag it Armed Radio. Kathy,
let me say this about the Bastrop meeting that I attended.
Kathy.
Mark Lestoria was asked about Walmart, and he said very condescendingly, if you had spent 50 minutes on the Internet, you would know that the reason why those Walmart stores closed was because, and get this, they were having labor troubles. So he didn't say anything about plumbing, so I guess they had ditched the plumbing excuse. And Walmart didn't get the talking points, but that's what he said. And that just fed into the suspicion that everything he was asked, the response came back and just heightened the suspicions. So he wasn't very good if his objective was to allay suspicions.
So in that one particular Walmart, it might have been labor disputes, but we've got multiple Walmarts being closed down all over the Southwest and the Southern states. From coast to coast, would they all be labor disputes?
I don't think you're going to get a straight answer, Mike. I can tell you it's Rebecca Paddock again. I don't think you're going to. I have not gotten a straight answer. I have asked many questions of many people, and I have not gotten a straight answer. And I don't think you're going to get a straight answer.
I can tell you my conclusion. From having been there and heard the explanation and everything I've read, I tend to believe that they are training for something in Texas because they think that there is some threat they might have to meet in Texas. I think that's it. Nothing else makes any sense.
Now,
what that threat is, I don't know, and I don't want to speculate.
Well,
it might be something if they disclosed to us, we would say, well, that's good. That's right. You should prepare for that. It might be something that we would say, we don't, ISIS invading, we don't consider that a big threat. We got that. You can back down from this. But we don't know. And I don't really much care if I know or you know or anybody on this call knows exactly what the threat is. I do care if our Texas governor knows about the threat. Our governor should know every single thing there is to know about what's going on here. And if he's good with it, I want to feel that I'm good with it, if I trust him and his objectives. But I don't really have that feeling now that they've engaged our governor. It's like they've just bypassed Texas and everybody in Texas, and they've taken over, and I'm not good with that.
Now, the new governor, Abbott, I don't know why, couldn't think of his name right off the top of my head, did send out the Texas Guard, and for those of you listening outside of Texas, Texas has an actual militia that is outside the control of the United States government, and it's called the Texas Guard. They're under the control of the governor, mostly for disaster relief and stuff like that and emergency situations, but they are trained military. We don't have tanks or artillery or anything like that, but they can be called up, and they've actually have units over there right now monitoring this whole situation. But here's my question. Here's where I get lost in the whole conspiracy stuff. I spent 10 years in the military, 10 years in the Army. I'm a combat vet. I was sent overseas. Traveled around the world on the government's dime, getting paid squat, but getting to go to a lot of cool places. At no time would I have ever followed any order that said, okay, we're going to take our tanks, we're going to drive over here to Bastrop, and we're just going to start taking guns from people and rounding people up. I mean, I don't think any soldier in the United States military would agree to that or even follow that order all the way up until the generals. And something that people seem to forget, we have close to 300,000 troops already in Texas stationed here. Fort Hood, out at El Paso, the naval bases on the coast, all the forts down in San Antonio, the medical facilities down in San Antonio. I mean, we've got all these troops here already. Why are we? I mean, Fort Hood is the largest military base in the continental United States. They have three armored divisions there. So I don't understand why we're bringing stuff in. Well, I don't think United States soldiers are going to be used, can be used in this capacity, because you'd have an outright mutiny. There are people, not just the privates, but all the way up to the generals would say, yeah, we're not doing that. Any thoughts?
Well, at the Bastrop meeting, I think that, and this was a hugely attended meeting. There must have been 500 people that came there in a room that could only seat 150. But they were turned away. They were turned away in the parking lot because they couldn't park. And a lot of these people were military, special forces, and they did not like hearing that their concerns evidenced a lack of concern about the military. They did not like to hear that. Basically, they're saying we're asking questions that our military would like to ask, but they can't. So we don't want to put them in a situation where they might have to defy an illegal order. We want to understand what's going on before it gets to that point. I agree with you that our military, by and large, over time, would refuse to obey an obviously unconstitutional order. But there's a lot of room in between that. There's a lot that goes on before you get to that point that we want to avoid.
Rob Kinney, you got any thoughts on that?
No, I just hope the training goes safe and that, you know, no lunatic jumps out there and thinks that his life's being threatened and fires on U.S. troops that are conducting training. You know, this is a crazy world we're living in, and if somebody felt threatened and their life was at stake, you know, Lord knows it probably ain't bad for somebody.
And, you know, that was a concern I had, too, is, you know, with all the conspiracy, with all the stuff going on, there's always going to be that one guy that buys it all, that thinks everything on Facebook is real, and he's going to go throw himself in front of a column or do something or start shooting people up. Co-host Joe Ellen here at the Central Texas Mancave has a question.
I think what you've just said is something to think about. I think there 5 years ago, the mood of the country was very different than it is now. I don't know if I'm more aware now than I was then, you know, if I was just caught up in other things. But to me, the mood of the country as a whole is much more paranoid, much more antagonistic, tremendously divisive on several issues. And I honestly think that the thing that concerns me the most about this exercise, which is just, it's bizarre. It's like, it's surreal. It sounds surreal from what I'm hearing. You know, it just sounds so surreal. But the thing that is the most concerning to me is not just what could be happening with the military, but also that the context that it's happening in is extremely explosive. I mean, look at what happened in Ferguson. Boom. You know, there was one horrible event, and a city was out of control for over a month.
Your thoughts, your thoughts, panel? Anybody?
It's a valid concern. I mean, both of them have valid concerns. When you are dealing in the private arena, you cannot control what other people are going to do and whether or not somebody feels threatened. And that's a valid, both of those are valid concerns. There could, problems could arise as a result.
Kathy?
Yes, I think so. And this has gone off of the military bases where they used to do these things and done them routinely. And now it's going into private property, and we don't know how it's going to overflow. But, you know, there could be communities that are used to seeing this, and they can look at something that seems odd and say, oh, that's just training. you can have someone out in some rural place in Texas, and then he sees people with guns, and, you know, he doesn't know that this is routine training, if that's what it is. And so he responds with to people with guns in a way he thinks he needs to. So it could go a lot of different ways, and I'm just sorry that it wasn't better presented, a better plan than this.
Matt Haisley, you have a thought on this?
Well, I lived in Texas for many years. I lived in San Antonio. And when I lived there, we had the situation. I was a former police officer. We had the Waco with David Koresh in his compound and everything. And a lot of people that were not in law enforcement felt that they killed him. They went in and just started the fires, everything. I mean, it was handled pretty poorly for a long period of time. And the media, the way it got out around that, a lot of people thought that they just went in and killed him. So now they think they're going to try to do this, well, they could be covertly, they say. They're trying to go in undetected. Well, you get certain towns, you're not going to be able to go undetected because people are going to, you're going to stand out like a sore thumb to them. They're going to go, hey, these people aren't from this area. Something's wrong. And when they start seeing military vehicles moving around, and people are going to start getting jumpy, and people are already scared, thinking that there's going to be some martial law, gun control. It's just fueling their minds. They're thinking it's finally coming to realize that this is what's really happening. If you're so afraid in this country now to sit there and say that you're a Christian or that you, what you believe in, because if you don't, the other side just pummels you until you give in. I mean, now they want to do, they want to do take the Confederate generals off that mountain or whatever it is, or the rock, and I'm like, I want to sandblast it off of there. I'm like, it's all a matter of control, they think. It's all a matter of somehow getting you to fall in line and do stuff, and that's what a lot of people feel. I talked to a lot of people. They think that this thing stinks to high heaven. Yeah, the media for it is probably pretty bad, which they're blocking out the media. You can't even cover it as a media person.
Well, I can see where they block the media out. I mean, from what I'm gathering, from what I've read about the whole Jade Helm exercise, is it's supposed to be an insertion. And the guys that the Green Berets, the Special Forces, the guys that are on the ground actually doing the exercise, insert themselves in the community, and then a limited number of troops have to find them. Basically, it's like hide and go seek. So I don't know about the tanks and all this other stuff. I think a lot of that has to do with just Facebook propaganda. I know out in Bastrop, haven't really seen a whole lot of that, maybe a few, just with the units that are out there searching for these special ops guys. But it goes back to, one, U.S. military service member would follow that order, and two, it's freaking Texas. Everybody owns a gun. It can't end well.
How do you find them? Okay, let's say they infiltrate into the community and they go hidden and nobody knows where they're at. How do they find them?
Well, I mean, that's what
door to door. What do? You go door to door and you go through people's houses looking for people.
And here's what I say: whatever information you get from that training, what experience you get, how does that translate anywhere else in the world? How you master the human Texas domain? How you find people in Bastrop, Texas? How does that translate overseas? It doesn't. So why are you here? Why are you doing this?
That's a good point. In Iraq? Are you going to use that in Iraq? Are you going to use that in Mannheim, Germany? Or are you going to use that where?
Well, in Iraq and Afghanistan, they kick down doors. So, you know,
there's that. We found him working at the Taco Bell, and he had this bumper sticker on his truck, his pickup truck. Okay, so what?
Well, how do we okay, find so how, then, so there are, this is a training exercise, right? And training teaches you skills that you apply in different places. I don't know how exactly the Secret Service are trained. But I will tell you this. A friend of mine went on a tour of the White House when it was still open, and she got separated from her daughter. She didn't realize that her daughter wasn't with her until a Secret Service man came up and gave her daughter back. These guys are trained so that when the tours come in, they remember which kid goes with which parent and can keep them together. I don't know what training they do to do that, but that's the end result. So there is something that they are getting out of looking for this. I don't know what the purpose is. Maybe it's, you know, if a terrorist tries to do the exact same thing, insert himself in U.S. society, how would you go about finding him? Maybe that's what they're trying to figure out.
They already have. They already have now. We got guys that are pledging their allegiance to ISIS now, and they're finding them through, you know, watching the internet feeds, the Twitter feeds, the, you know, everything like that. Not going house to house.
Well, are they going? So I don't know what the. So, like I said, I've asked a lot of questions. I haven't gotten a lot of straight answers.
Yeah.
I have not heard of anybody going house to house in Bastrop.
And that seems to
well,
be.
Well, tell me that you get feedback on how you got detected. You got spotted because of this. I say, you're doing this in Texas. What are the signs that you got spotted? Did you eat the husk off of your tamale? Did you order ketchup with your barbecue? I mean, is that what outed you as someone who just didn't fit in?
All dead giveaways. All dead giveaways, especially ketchup on barbecue. Now, we got to take a break. Kathy, can you hang around? I knew you said you could give me two.
No, I really got to, I'm sorry I got to beg off, but it's been great, and thanks for having me, and I hope you'll ask me about ask me on again.
You betcha. Kathy Glass, 2014 gubernatorial candidate. Hope she makes a run for it again in 4 years. Kathy, thanks for coming on. For the rest of y'all, mute up. We're going to be right back talking about Jade Helm. Should we be scared? I'm not scared, but should we be scared? We'll get back more on this. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Now, I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you'll need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll look.
They don't come back there. They live all the way in the back.
Probably can all just
behind
share
the park, and there's nobody there. So yeah, you can share a pole, and I can take a pole. And...
All right, welcome back to the show. Today's broadcast brought to you by Eat24.com. Eat24.com, put it in your phone as a free app off of iTunes or Google Play. Put in the zip code of where you're at. They will find a restaurant to deliver food to you anywhere. It's Eat24.com and the Eat24.com app. Joining me now on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, Ms. Rebecca Paddock, who ran for the United States Senate from the great state of Texas. Mr. Rob Kinney, who is a reality TV star, gunsmith, retired vet, owns a gun shop right now somewhere in the continental United States, and our own Matt Haisley from Straight Talk with Matt Haisley, that you can hear every Monday and Friday night, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here on Armed Radio Global. When we went into the break, my co-host, Joe Allen, had a question. Go ahead, Joe.
So, thanks, Mike. So, some of the things that I'm hearing sound like basic detective-type exercises. like we're trying to find you. We followed you. I mean, I watch a lot of crime television, and I assume that every detective is brilliant and has great hair. But it sounds like a lot of the things that you're talking about, like, oh, we found you because you put ketchup on your barbecue. It's just basic deductive reasoning that you would think that a section of the military would already have in place. Or am I missing, or is there something else more sinister? I mean, it does sound sinister, but I'm wondering if there's more to it that it makes it more sinister that I'm not hearing about.
Well, to me, I will say that when I go into a restaurant, even a barbecue restaurant, I am not watching for who's putting ketchup on their barbecue. I may be watching, you know, for aggressive behavior so that if I start to see something going down, I can get out, right? But I'm not watching for who's putting ketchup on their barbecue.
Well, I think from what I've read, and I guess let me put a different perspective on this. From what I've read, it's not the troops that are going there to try to find somebody that are being trained. It's the special ops, the Green Berets, the special forces personnel who are trying not to be found. So they got to go in.
I will tell you from my perspective, if that's the case, I have a real problem with that, because that means that you're using a large percentage of the military, and they're not getting anything out of it. So the people that are out looking, this needs to be a training opportunity for them, too. They need to be getting something out of it. And the chances that somebody is going to spend that amount of money on a training exercise for a handful of people and not leverage it as a training exercise for everybody else is stupid beyond belief. Well, I would never do that as an executive in corporate America, and I can't imagine that the military would be doing that either.
I think Rob can agree with me, being Army veterans and military veterans, that any time the military does anything, common sense is not one of the factors.
It's not one of the key names.
So, okay, so as someone who went through 2000, the Y2K, right?
Yeah, the big scare from that, which was
big scare from Y2K, and has a father who
funny, by the way.
Who watches a lot of Fox News and who is a pseudo pep prepper.
And I heard today on the internet that Fox News is not real news. Just go ahead.
But you know, so he's 83. He just celebrated his birthday. He's 83. He's a little bit of a prepper, little bit of a cowboy. You know, pretty tough guy. I've always imagined that if there was a total Y2K meltdown and life stopped existing the way we know it, that whether it's from ISIS or government or whatever it is, that he would get on his horse and he would go ride his horse to each one of his kids' houses, and he'd probably have some kind of thing rigged up with water and supplies for us. He buys us flashlights a lot, and we have lanterns from him. So he's somebody who is thinking in terms of, what am I going to do if the world kind of goes to hell in a handbasket? And my question is this exercise, because we're talking about finding the special ops people who are busy hiding. My question is, maybe they're training a group of people to find the Americans who are planning on going off the grid because they don't want to pay for their Affordable Health Care Act.
Good question. Because I've known of people that have gotten in trouble for going off the grid. They get hunted down and they get heavily fined by the government, and they just want to go live with, you know.
I know a doctor.
With a generator.
I know an amazing doctor here in Austin who decided he wasn't going to accept insurance, just wasn't going to accept it, and was visited by men in coats, you know, black coat, you know, the suits, who said, "What's going on? We need to find out what's going on with you."
I think the longer and more you talk out, kind of like, you know, we get to me, my show is getting more and more like, you know, InfoWars and stuff like that, where, you know, a lot of the things are brought up or stuff like this. and they automatically, you make the radar that you're against the government, which I'm not against the government. I mean, I just don't like when the government does things that that go against the Constitution. The reason why our Constitution was set up by our forefathers is because they had the sense to that it wasn't going right before. So they all sat down and said, hey, we need to do is draft this to protect, you know, protect our people.
Yep,
and then now they go around the Constitution. They drive over it like it's a, you know, like it's a you know, a gravel driveway, and they don't give a rat's ass whether it has anything to do with you or not. And then you, if you complain about it, like you said earlier, you can't sue the government. You have to give the permission to sue the government. That makes no sense at all.
Rebecca, do you have a thought on that?
Well, you heard what I had to say when I was running for office. I'd say that you need to be involved in writing my speeches for the next time.
Well, you should have won. We'd have been up there right now. I could have been hobnobbing.
I can tell you that if I had won, or if Kathy had won, things would be very different, right? Because Kathy's not going to stop asking questions, and neither would I. I mean, I agree with her. The governor ought to know what's happening in Texas.
Exactly.
And you know what? Cornyn and Cruz ought to know what's happening in Texas as well.
When you have your congressmen and your senators that go and they try to find out the information, and they're on select committees, and they would, like when they were talking about these illegal concentration camps where they had housed these, detained these illegal aliens that were coming across the border, and they would not let them in to view the camps. They said, no, you're not allowed in. And they were on the select committees in Texas, and I'm like going, how can you stop them? That makes no sense at all.
Rob, you got a thought on that?
Well, we go back to the transparency that we're not seeing and trust. Government trust in our officials and our elected personnel that, you know, that we can rest assured that they have our best interests as a country. But a lot of times we're not seeing that trust. And, you know, you have a popular, and a lot of my customers come in and they ask me questions, and I'm not seeing a whole lot of government trust. You know, the stomping and overriding of the Constitution, you know, the demonizing of the police, and now all this Southern flag, stars and bars, trying to make it a hate issue instead of a history issue. I mean, sandblast the Confederate generals off of Stone Mountain? Really? I don't get that.
Well, we talked about, Mike and I talked about this, you know, the point you're catching on right there and you're touching on is it makes no sense to do what they're doing. But it's one little thing. What's the next thing? What's the next thing? That we've got to get them in line. Okay, we got them to do this. Now we get them to do this. And then we get them to do this. And it keeps going one after the other.
And pedophilia, that's called grooming.
They want to sandblast the Confederate generals off Stone Mountain. They want to do is remove graves and dig up buried generals. Well, I can understand if you want to take the statue down. If you don't like that, you think they were racist, fine. But when you start digging people up and you start moving people because you don't like them, their graves and stuff like that, I'll tell you what, when are you going to stop? Where does it stop from after that?
It won't stop.
Well, I think that there's been something that's really been hit on that I'd like to underscore for a second, if you don't mind. And that is that we've talked about this before, that in my view, the Constitution is a contract between the federal government, the states, and the people. It's a three-way contract. And trust in that contract is part of that relationship. And what we're seeing right now is a breakdown, not only in the trust that the government has for the people, but also the people has for the government. What we're seeing is a breakdown of that relationship. And the way to fix a relationship is not to create bigger boundaries. The way to fix a relationship is to break down the boundaries.
That's right. You got to be able to sit there and show the people, and like you said, being transparent, if he was transparent. Benghazi was one of the biggest things that a lot of people, it bothered people about this administration. If they would have came out right from the get-go and said, we screwed up, it'd have been done. It'd have been over with in a day.
And you know what? People would not be upset about Jade Helm now.
They would understand, okay, you screwed up, you owned up to it. But when they sit there and they say, no, it was a video, and they spontaneous deal, and it just kept fueling it. And a lot of people, you know, there's a lot of people that are liberals, they sit there and they just, they just keep talking about that. Well, there's something to it. I always was taught, if there's enough smoke, there's enough fire. And the thing that bothers me is, it gets people, is they do things. What was Robbie Manuel? What was the famous line that he said? I'm trying to word it correctly, but he says, anytime you have an incident, you know, make sure you use it for your agenda. And he was talking about Sandy Hook. I don't care what anybody, I've seen so much on Sandy Hook, I've seen so many things, and I tell you what, I've had Wolfgang Helbig on, I've had multiple people I've talked to about it. It was a hoax. It was set up to advance gun control. And I don't want to get off of our topic of what we're at, but that's what gets people so they don't believe the government anymore.
Well, that and the advent of the whole social network. I mean, I get on Facebook every day, and my personal Facebook page maybe has 100 people on it that I know personally, and I, you know, trade pictures and say hello, and then I have the Mike Allen Facebook page, which I say yes to everything, just so I can get show prep material and kind of be up on what's going on, and it is just filled with either left or right wing posters, Lady Gray, the Tea Party, Steve Marmol. I mean, it's just amazing how far and how left and right posting memes with information, and that's really what's dividing us and creating this culture of fear, really.
Folks need to focus on what brings us together, what we agree on. Normally, people will agree on the why. They may not agree on the how, but they'll normally agree on the why. And instead of people talking about the differences in the how and hating each other over the differences in the how, why don't we talk about what we all care about, what's important to all of us, and moving that agenda forward?
Rob, what do you think? Rob, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm breaking up a little bit.
Do you think the fear-mongering is a problem with the propagandas from Fox News and MSNBC and everything?
It's a sad day, but I have trust issues, too, and I know it, and I don't really like to share them too much, but I really don't. And I really feel that there's just not a great deal of trust in our country right now. And I'm seeing it, I'm hearing it, and how or why, I don't know. All I can do is keep my eyes open and try to make sense of the whole Jade Helm thing. Why, when our country is almost at the point of bankruptcy, are they spending all these, it's got to be billions of dollars, to locate all these vehicles around and conduct this training when they could have did it on their forts, their posts, their naval bases, you know, and basically did the same thing and not endanger the public. And that's the main thing that I have that really eats at me, is the loss of life because of the military's equipment. And, it's going to happen. I mean, you mark my words. I'm already hearing traffic accidents and families dying. Local news not carrying this story at all, but a trucker's got pictures and he's sending me pictures, moving ammo out of warehouses, going to Mexico.
You get the farm that they're going to accidentally come up onto or something like that, with some farmers out there, rancher, who's out there in Texas, that all of a sudden they think they can go there, the military part of the exercise. They roll up on him, and he pulls out, you know, guns, everything. He's being invaded.
I see a lot of stuff happening.
I mean, that is an invasion. I mean, that's a ridiculous, nonsensical.
But how do you stop them? How do you give in? You sit there, and a tank rolls up to your front door, and yeah, he's invading you. But what rights do you have to stop him? None, because you know why? He's going to sit there and drive through your house if he wants to. Nobody's reporting on it.
So let's be clear. You do have a right to protect yourself and your private property.
Correct.
Now,
if you go to protect yourself against the military and they're got all their tanks and everything, you're going to die.
Yes, you most likely will. You have the right to but we need to be careful about our wording, though, right? It's not a matter of you don't have the right to protect yourself. You do have the right to protect yourself.
Well, correct. You do have the right to protect yourself. Will it help you? Probably not, in that case of the military.
I agree with that statement. I just want to be clear that we are using the proper words to describe the scenario.
Well, and I think something to think about is that there's two things. There's going to be the person like myself who is living in her own world and thinking about her singing gig on Friday and whether or not she should make a cake, this chocolate cake, or should she make a cherry cake pie dessert, and totally unprepared for any kind of anomaly like that we're discussing, okay? And then there's going to be the person who is like overprepared and with a hair trigger and a chip on their shoulder and a paranoid mindset and military people with.
So to be quite honest,
I am
more concerned about people like you than the people that are overprepared. Because you know what? The
right.
people that are overprepared
right.
know that Jade Helm is happening.
Right.
There are people that don't mess around on Facebook, or if they do, they're only looking at pictures of cats and beer.
Mm-hmm.
that don't watch the news, don't read the newspaper. They have no idea Jade Helm is happening. And then when they come up against it, when they see it, they are taken completely by surprise. They have no form of reference for this at all. And that is a bigger concern for me mm-hmm. than people in that are preppers that may know about it and are worried or antagonistic even.
Yeah, the preppers that see it coming that know about it, they're going to document it. They're going to take out their phones and video it, where these other people are going to be like overwhelmed by what's going on.
When people panic, you don't know what they're going to do.
And I'm going to be sending out my "I told you so" tweets.
But you know, the bad thing about it is it's not just like somebody that bakes the cake that lives in Texas. But there's people that live in, like I live in Iowa. There's people that live in Iowa that I talk to. They're like, "I don't know anything about it," and I'm like, "You know nothing about it. It has nothing. It's not right here. It's not in your face. It doesn't affect you."
Yeah,
and that's the problem. With politics and with anything that it's a social issue that they, as long as it's not affecting them, they don't care. And I'm like, you gotta care. They're chipping away our Constitution. You need to start paying attention. You're gonna come 10, 15 years down the road and you're gonna go, wait a minute,
oops.
What happened?
Yeah.
Well, you sat there and let them do it.
Well, guys,
tell them about that.
We're at the end of our segment. I want to thank Rebecca Paddock for coming on. Rob Kenny, always a pleasure. We need to have you back again.
Yes, sir. Give me a call. Anything weapon-related or storing of ammo or just use of force.
You got it, buddy. We'll call you. And Matt Haisley, heard every Monday and Friday night, 9 p.m., right here on Armed Radio Global. Thank you for stopping by, sir.
Thanks, Mike.
All right. Thanks,
thank you,
guys.
Thanks, Mike.
You bet. We're going to take a short break. It's the top of the hour. And when we come back, the shenanigans will continue. Stick around. As in studio, we have Joe Ellen. We have Dani Blaze.
Yay.
Here early.
Taking selfies.
And Patrick Danger Davis, who just kind of wandered on in. So stick around. We'll be right back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
Is your wife wicked hot? Or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service,
reasonable rates, satisfaction guaranteed,
licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern. Spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spring. Exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
I want a little sugar. I want a little sweetness down in my soul. I could use some loving, oh, so bad. I feel so funny, I feel so sad. I want some steam on my clothes. Maybe I can fix things up so they'll go. What's the matter, Daddy? Come on, save my soul.
I want a little sugar in my bowl. Our own Joe Allen. Sugar in my bowl. Sounding good. Welcome back to the show. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by eat24.com. Put the app in your phone via iTunes or Google Play. Put in the zip code of where you're at, and they will find some place to deliver food to you wherever you're at. It's like having a food truck in your pants. eat24.com. Welcome back to the show in the Armed Radio Global Central Texas Man Cave. Joe Allen, who is singing that beautiful song, recorded right here.
Thank you. Do you know what Dangerous said about it?
After what?
He thought it was the cheese guy.
The cheese guy?
I think his beard is growing up into his ears.
You have an ingrown...
Whatever we were listening to last time, you know, the... Good save. The guy that does the
the slow jazz kind of thing, but he'll do like
rap song.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought it was.
I realized that
after
the incredibly low IQ of Danger Davis.
Hey now.
And of course our own incomparable. Beautiful, lovely.
Sensational. Selfie sexy. Queen.
Humble.
I don't need to be humble, bitch. I worked hard to get like this.
Yeah. You look okay. Come on, girl. All right.
Can I rant?
Go ahead, I've been waiting for
8 hours to rant about this. Okay.
You go around with your bad self.
I saw a picture today on Facebook, and I was ready to go through the roof today. And it's a picture of Caitlyn Jenner, former Bruce Jenner, and Serena Williams next to each other. And the picture says, "Dear white people," Serena Williams is on the left. It says, "This is a woman, not a man." I guess apparently she said she has been called a woman that looks like a man. In all fairness, she's buffer than most men I know.
Hell of a tennis player.
Someone tweeted that. Someone tweeted and said, "Well, of course she won. She's built like a man."
Hey, let's call it what it is. Men are stronger than women, but that's neither here nor there. Then on the right side, it has a picture of Caitlyn Jenner, and it says, "This is a man, not a woman." And at the very bottom, it says, "Does anyone else find it extremely disturbing that we have to actually explain this?"
Hold the motherfucking phone.
Sorry, I said the F word. That'll be my only one. This one, I promise. I'm so upset that, one, it says, "Dear white people," because this has zero things to do with race.
I know. That's what I'm saying. Why gotta be white people?
It has nothing to do with race. Someone's mad because someone tweeted and said Serena Williams looks like a man.
I'm still kind of waiting for my white privilege kick in, by the way.
I'm using the shizzle out of my thin privilege right now. My thin privilege, my pretty girl privilege, and my white privilege. I'm pulling all the cards out. No stops. Uh-oh. I'm so mad.
Don't talk for a one-eyed fat
because
man.
This is the stuff I was talking about last week when I was like, the reason that I think America is stupid is because we're fighting over stupid stuff like this. And I know I shouldn't be mad about this, but one, no one said Serena Williams was a man. So shut up, you stupid, dumb people. Two, I mean, in all fairness, she is ripped like a man. But
she has tremendous upper body strength.
Holy Hanukkah, have you seen her play tennis? I wouldn't want to see her come at me with a racket.
She's got a 106 or 107 mile an hour serve or something like that.
I don't want her coming at me. Because she'll axe murder me with like a flick of the finger. But another thing that is irritating me, besides this whole...
Ooh, Serena Williams, Ronda Rousey, UFC.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
That'd be hot.
My jimmies have been rustling.
I'd watch that. No, my issue is one, it has nothing to do with race. I'm not sure why it says dear white people. Like, can you go jump in front of a train and
Well, liberals have to make it about race to give it some sort of legitimacy.
And it's very possible that the person who tweeted the original stupid tweet is a total white twit. The person who said...
Yeah, but why is it... Who cares what color it is?
Serena Williams has a upper body like a man. No one said she is a man. She is very, very muscular. Most women are not like that, and that's probably why she's, you know, top-notch tennis player.
Her and her sister, twin sister. She's got a twin sister. It looks just, you know, similar.
Yeah. But that, so nothing to do with race. No one called Serena Williams a man, so I don't know why all these people have their shit in a twist. And two, I find it extremely disturbing that whatever you grew up as, whatever background you come from, Bruce Jenner is now a woman. He has all his things.
Still can't wrap my head around
it. I know, and you know what? And when I graduated, to get college credit for my AP class in...
It would be rude not to eat her
high school,
pie, which
I
assume
had,
is
stop,
not only
you always
hot,
soundboard. Let me talk.
Moist.
I'm going to take you away from that soundboard. Don't make me take my anger out on you and be all womanly. Uh-oh. Yeah, I'm going to go full win. So that pissed me off. Because, one, most people don't know anything about the transgender community. It's not like you just get to wake up one day and be like, I think I'm going to be a man today. Like, the process that you have to go through... You have to go through years of therapy. You have to actually be diagnosed. You can't just wake up one day and be like, I'm going to go in and just have a full-on sex change. No, you have to actually go through so many things. But so, one, it's just ignorance because you don't know what you're talking about. So you're getting mad over, one, a stupid tweet, which I can't really talk, so I'm getting mad over a stupid picture. But I feel like this needs to be explained.
So you're saying as a guy, I can't just wake up one morning and want to go through a flop it off of me.
Well, first you'd have to shave that beard, which, come on, let's be real.
Yes, be real.
No, okay, so it usually starts with therapy. Like, you have to be diagnosed, and you start the hormone process. Mm-hmm. That's so you know, you start getting either more feminine or masculine features, whatever way you're going. And then you start doing the sex changes and stuff. Now, luckily, Caitlin has lots of money. Her process is a lot quicker. Most of the time, the process takes a long time. So then I see this thing on Twitter. I don't know who posted it, but somebody that I follow posted a screenshot. And it was like, something about him getting the Arthur Ashe Courage Epsi Award, but Serena Williams is called a woman that looks like a man. Okay, well, Serena Williams, what is she doing for courage? And what is she doing to give people courage? She's a kick-ass tennis player. Cool, go chase your dreams. I feel like, especially when you're in a big American icon, like Caitlyn was when she was Bruce Jenner, you can't, like, that's courage right there. You are an Olympic athlete. People grew up, you were their hero, like, and all of a sudden you, like, drop this stuff on people. That's courage to finally stand up after 50-something, 60, how old is she, like, 60-something, 50?
So the lesson here is, don't marry a Kardashian.
Apparently so.
Now, you don't think it's all...
Oh, and apparently, no, so then the person that I follow said, after they were like, oh, we're so lost, why did Serena Williams say, why do people say she looks like a man, but then Caitlyn gets the courage award, and then he says, but this is what happens when money is more powerful than morals, and also you can't expect lost people to know they lost, but guess what? Shit only gonna get worse. You know it's crazy when straight men can't even have ESPN no more. Only place left for us to voice our opinion without being offended in the barbershop. Serena Williams has nothing to do with courage. Is she in any activist movements that I should have looked that up maybe, but...
Well, no. Serena Williams has everything to do with perseverance, training, dedication, pursuit of excellence.
She's freaking awesome.
She's amazing.
Like, mind-blowing awesome.
But what again, does that mean? And not only Serena, but her sister, too.
Yeah, I know. Whoever bred them should have kept popping them out. That's all I'm saying.
It would take over the world. And not only that, not only is Serena a great athlete and trains very hard and is committed not only as an ambassador to the sport of tennis, which I have no interest in whatsoever, but I will watch a Serena Williams highlights on ESPN. She's also just a very classy lady. Very classy.
Again, one said she wasn't.
No, but the point, I'm trying to make your point, is none of that has anything to do with a 1970s era Olympic gold medalist who married a batshit crazy family of attention whores, and then all of a sudden now is turning into a woman.
But it's not all of a sudden. It has zero things to do all of a sudden. It's not ever all of a sudden. 98% of the time that someone is a transgender person, they start having all that before they're even 5 years old. It's not like you just wake up. I mean, I watched the documentary that he had in his whole speech. Like,
he thought he was a woman the whole time he was in the triathlon.
And the reason
the gold
he
medals,
did it is because he was like,
models,
and a lot of them do. A lot of them can't cope with
children.
That. When you are in the spotlight like that, especially like an American hero, like you said, you grew up watching him. That's a lot of pressure on somebody. You can't be yourself. You have to be the pitch perfect person of a hero. You can't just say
you have to be what they want. You have to be what they want you to be.
And especially back in that time, that's not acceptable. Hell, it's not even expect. It's 2015. The freaking gays can get married, but you can't accept somebody because they aren't who they were born to be. Like, when you have that much pressure on you, especially when that was definitely not...
Back in the 70s, yeah.
Yeah, that was definitely not acceptable then. You have to do what you have to do. Like, that was his dream. He wanted to be an Olympic. He wanted to do that. You can't... I couldn't imagine having to battle your whole life for that. And then finally, after you're damn near dead, get the courage to be who you want to be. You don't just wake up one day and say, hey, you know, even this new show coming out on TLC... This girl is transgender. Well, she was born a male. She's a female. But even her parents are like, when she was like 3 years old, she's like, am I a boy or a girl? She was born a boy. Recognized herself as a woman. It's not so simple as I just want to wake up and have a dick. I would love to be a guy for a day just to see what it's like. Because being a girl's for the birds. I don't know why anyone would want to do it. But
titties.
You don't just wake up and say I'm somebody different than I am. It's just so much ignorance. People don't know about it and people don't care about it because one, religious beliefs. Two, that you don't understand it, and that's what most people are prejudiced against is stuff they don't understand.
They don't understand. Well, we got a phone call coming
in. Sweaty.
Hang on till
if
after
Matt
the break.
It's Matt Haisley. I'm going to be so
hang
upset.
On till after the break phone call, and we'll call you back. Right now, we're going to take a break in the man cave. Joe Allen, Danger Davis, and Dani Blaze, mid-rant. We'll be right back after these messages. You're listening to the Armed Radio Global Network, and you're on the air.
I want some sugar in my bowl. I want some sugar in my bowl.
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold? Do you just want to take a hot shower? Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century. Quality 24-hour service, reasonable rates, satisfaction guaranteed, licensed and insured. And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today at 1-855-624-4280. That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. Online 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
I want a little sugar.
That's our own Joe Allen singing in the background. You can listen to her live Friday, July 17th, happy hour at Two Rivers Market in Georgetown. She'll be singing 6 to 8 p.m. If you'd like to know more information about that, go to our Facebook page, and she'll have all her times and everything posted there, and you can go check her out. Welcome back to the show. Now joining us on the Ring Central Celebrity Hotline, welcome caller, your name and where are you calling from?
LaDonna.
Hey, LaDonna, how you doing? You're on the air.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, what's going on? You listening to the show or what?
No, I'm not listening to the show. What kind of show is this? I'll know next time.
What the heck? Man, LaDonna, you're killing me. LaDonna
is... I'm listening to the show.
Go, okay, there you go. LaDonna is one of my fellow Funny Bones instructors who filled in for me tonight.
She's the one that always comments on my hair. I worked at the Blind Squirrel. I think she always complimented my hair.
Yeah, remember Danny at the Blind Squirrel had the pink hair?
Yes.
Yeah,
and then red hair, and then you dyed your hair the same color as mine. It was awesome.
Well, I know I'm on the air. Can I ask a question, or you want me to, like...
No, ask away.
No, go ahead and ask a question. Go ahead. This is live radio. I mean, this is true life.
This is uncut.
This is uncut.
But this is a business question, Mark.
No, I will not have your baby for money.
No, then you're not the mama.
The lie detector determined that was a lie.
So what's up, LaDonna?
Mark, I really do have a question, but you want me to text it to you?
Is it like super secret or what?
No.
Hell, talk about it on there, LaDonna. Go for it.
Ask me.
Okay. Gratuity. Do I pay the gratuity?
No, they should have taken it out of the bill.
They did.
Yeah, that's that handwritten part in the bill. Nope, you don't pay anything. I mean, yeah, you pay the bill. You pay the bill.
Just whatever the bill, don't be adding nothing else to it?
And the gratuity. You pay the total thing.
No, they didn't put it in here.
Well, just pay whatever's on the bill. Pay the total on the bill.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
That's it.
Thank you, LaDonna.
Guys, hey, that was wonderful. Bye, Radio Land.
Bye, LaDonna.
Bye.
Bye.
I thought she was calling that. Yelling at me or something.
I thought she was calling in, man.
I was ready. I was like, let's do this,
calling
LaDonna.
About the dang class.
So anyways, I feel like... Stop posting stupid shit on the internet.
Joe, do you have a thought on this, or are you still playing your games? You're as bad as this guy.
No, I'm not. I'm not.
Over there playing Words for Friends.
I didn't have Word for Friends, but I was waiting for one of my guys from India to text me tell me what's going on Skype. I am actually working while I'm doing this and playing and multitasking.
Well, tell him to call it.
So here's the deal.
All right.
I get Bruce Jenner's or Caitlyn's courage. I get all of that. I feel the same way, and this is me, and I'm kind of, I like closure. We are, and I remember in 1976, I was 16 years old, when Bruce Jenner won everything that he won. And it was amazing, and he became a hero. And I don't know why this makes me emotional, but it really does. We're never going to have a Bruce Jenner funeral, but we're never going to see him again either.
Nope.
And I find that very disconcerting. Am I weeping in my beer over it? No, I'm not. But I do find it, I do feel like we're missing something important.
Well, kind of the word where I've reached a point in my life.
I don't think you should have won the award.
Where I... First of all, publicity awards mean nothing.
Which Amen. Is what that was.
Unless I win.
And you know, it's just another thing that they feed the populace to, you know, to give us distractions or to give us things that happen. Yeah, I mean, it's just another way to keep the masses appeased.
I mean, I'm not saying he should have won or not won. That's not what it is.
But where I've gotten to in my life, that unless it costs me money, I don't really care.
And that's how it should be. But so like you were saying, you know, it makes you really sad that you're not going to have the Bruce Jenner funeral.
I feel the same way about Sally, about Meg Ryan's face.
So... That's actually one of the...
No.
I do. I'm serious. I feel the same way about Meg Ryan's face. She's had enough work that she doesn't look like herself.
And the woman that
really?
We loved...
Really?
She's had... Any person that's had... And Priscilla Presley. These women have... And I'm not against plastic surgery, frankly.
But there's the people that you know. I mean, these are celebrities, and we live in a celebrity culture, and I'm not that big on celebrities per se. But they are a part. Like, I was sad when Jim Garner died. I loved watching him. People are, you know, there are certain people, they're a part of our culture. They're a part of our childhood. Robin Williams, when he passed away, it was a blow, you know?
Well,
are
what,
they celebrities? Do we have a personal connection to them? No. But they are a part of the fabric of our lives. And when they change so drastically through plastic surgery or transgender surgery, it's sad to me that we don't get a chance to say goodbye to what we knew and loved and valued. Amen.
And that's actually one of the hardest things for families to go through, is that they don't get the opportunity to mourn what they think they lost, but you're not really losing, per se, the person. You're just losing their outer. They're still the same person. They still are. They're just now being more expressive. And from what I've seen since he's done the sex change, he actually seems like a stronger person. He seems more opinionated. It seems like he's, you know, finally being himself. But, I mean, that's what a lot of transgender families go through, and they actually have specific counselors just for that, because you're losing what you know to something that comes a lot quicker than...
Well, I'm here on the internet, so I'm looking at Meg Ryan. She's not as bad as... What's the gal that played on...
okay, yeah.
The Tom Cruise movie. Jerry Maguire. Who is that? Bridget Jones. Now, Renee Zellweger doesn't even look like she used to look.
No.
She looks like she's had work, but she doesn't look that bad.
No, there's one picture where she looks like I wouldn't have even known who she was if I hadn't seen it. And
all right, I gotta look her up real quick.
Yeah, but that's...
I think the point is that it's still like...
The point is that we're on the radio and you're talking to the microphone.
Well, I need
God damn.
I need my
own
mic.
Shit, Sheila. Mike. Freaking... Oh my God.
Yeah, Renee Zellweger, right?
No, I'm looking up Meg Ryan.
And I, you know, and I
oh, she's old. She's like 60 years old.
So, and look,
I've
here's
seen
the
old people that look a lot better.
Look, here's the deal. It's her decision, it's her life, it's whatever.
I'm so pro but plastic surgery.
I'm not anti-plastic surgery.
I mean, that's too much.
It's the idea that what we've known and loved is gone. And it's gone for good, unless they have reversal surgery.
I'm just saying, Meg Ryan looks like an effed up version of Sabrina Spellman's aunt.
I mean, Renee Zellweger doesn't even look like... She's like a totally different person.
Yeah.
Look at that. Stop looking at these pictures. They're scaring me.
Yeah. This is like plastic surgery gone.
That's tabloid crap. You know, they always when this show makes it.
I can't wait to be in the tabloids.
And we're going to be in the tabloids. We're always going to have that picture like we just got out of the shower, stubbed our toe, and stuck a nail in our ass. It's like, you know, it's like, Mike Allen has an affair with Jennifer Lopez, you know?
Wow, of all the people
hey, I can dream.
Mine's going to be like...
It's fake anyway, so why not?
Danger.
Yeah, why not? Yeah.
I'm going to be like, no, Seth
Danger
wasn't
Davis.
In my bed.
I'll be calling Seth. Jennifer. It's like, hey, you know, they already said
right.
front page, man.
Seth's seen what appeared to be sleeping in Patrick's lap while on road trip to the coast for a romantic couple's getaway.
No, I don't have 20 cats.
Seth states that he lost change on the floor and he was tired.
But he did find his change.
So, when we do get on the tablet, just FYI, I know Photoshop.
It's off.
I don't think you get to
fix all that.
Okay. Well, I don't think they do that in the tablet. I think they try to. I think they Photoshop against you. That's another thing I'm going to rant about. Then, now that we're talking about plastic surgery, I hate all this. You guys got like, okay. I love Kylie Jenner. I love the Kardashians. They're my guilty pleasure. They're all fucking crazy. I love it. I don't care. They're making money being crazy.
Hey, you know what?
Whatever. So, who keeps giving me alcohol?
For every F-bomb you drop, I will send you back to the store dressed like that.
Yeah, well, hopefully my ex still isn't there, which I will rant about in a little bit after this. Okay, so I love
F-bombs.
The Kardashians.
Hold on, I got to catch up. How many do we had? At two, right?
MF.
Is it like that time of the month?
Yes, okay. It is.
Yes.
I was just wondering.
It literally is. And normally I'd be mad that you said that, but since you're actually
Little
being
League.
Factual.
Little League it is.
Little League it is that. No, so everyone was all like, oh, the world, she's so fake and blah, blah. Who cares? You know what? Kylie Jenner looks a crap load better with her lip injections. That's all I'm saying. I mean, she looks...
Is that when you take the fat from the ass and put it in?
There's different types. No, it's not when you do that. She had actual... She went to a doctor and did it. And the dumb people...
What the hell are you doing to that bottle?
It was called the Kylie Jenner challenge. And you, like, shove your lips in, like, a bottle to where it, like, sucked it. And you just kept doing it. Because everyone was... The fact that you're so stupid to think that that is what... You deserve to have your lips rupture at that point. That's called natural selection. If you're that stupid, go kill yourself.
Joellen's over here.
But everyone's always like, oh my god, this celebrity got...
So what's rent do over here? What are we...
Those are those DS lips.
They look more of a little delicious.
Those are those DS lips, but we're going to get to that later. But everyone's always like, oh, well, that celebrity got... plastic surgery, and she's, like, ashamed, and she doesn't have any confidence, and blah, blah, blah. No, that is not, and maybe they don't...
She's got a crap load of money and time on her hands.
It means, hey, I don't like this about my face, so I'm gonna go pay this doctor money to make that how I want it. Boom, hello. Damn. I wish I had that ability.
I gotta talk about that.
She lives in a culture, I've lived in L.A., absolutely. She lives in a culture that is so... looks oriented. You have no idea.
The pressure
you have
is
no,
unreal.
It is absolutely unreal. And when I say it's unreal, it's
You can throw it now. We're in a
no,
don't
stand when I'm talking.
When I say the pressure is unreal, it's like the pressure is to be unreal. The pressure is to be unreal. The pressure is to be surreal, super real, more than real, not real. It's very intense. And I mean, I was there, and the man that I was, my former matrimonial partner, was a photographer, and was, you know, knew his...
That must have been a cool job in LA.
He was, and you know, I mean, I knew a few, you know, whatevers here and there. Somebody from Sanford and Son lived next door to me, but what was interesting about it is that even in my little, you know, dinky retail job, there were women who were getting this type of surgery done, getting the nails done. They went to work to sell hubcaps, looking
decked out,
and they were pressured about it. They were under pressure about it, and so I'm with you on the idea that if I don't like something about my body, I absolutely have the opportunity to go and make that better.
Rock
you know,
on.
I can go walk every day and lose weight. I can do all kinds of things, you know. But I also understand that in that culture, you don't even get a balanced view of what your body truly looks like, what your face truly looks like, because the comparison is intense, and the idea that... that the whole focus and conversation is all about the way you look. You know, like I come in and I say, oh, your hair's a different color. How cool. That's it. There's no part of me that says, should I do mine now? What do you think? I mean, we don't have a 20-minute conversation about it, and there's no trauma or drama attached to that. That is the norm in that culture. I'm telling you it is.
I don't know. All I'm saying is she looks smoking hot.
She does.
And I love her style. I love
what's her name?
Kylie Jenner.
Kylie, like K-Y?
K-Y-L-I-E. I love her. She is sassy, and I love her style, and she has... Oh, Jesus. Like, oh, no, you gotta go look at her Instagram. Her Instagram is... I follow her.
Hey.
No, they're all beautiful. Everyone hates them for being ditzy dumb and Kim getting famous off making a sex tape, but they have very successful clothing lines.
Oh, she has your hair.
Yeah, she just did it... I don't know. Look, I'll show you her Instagram.
See, how can somebody want to be a woman and father something that beautiful? I don't get
because
it.
Because he wanted.
Hold on.
Because she wanted to be a woman prior to.
I would
here follow her Instagram. You can just swipe. No, I mean they're all beautiful. They are gorgeous women. They may be crazy. They may be stupid. But one, like Joellen said, that's what they live in. Like L.A. is a different world than
it is.
So have you had conversations with her?
No. I haven't had. She didn't have time to talk to me. I just stalk her pictures.
Get
like
her on the show.
I
don't have
time to talk to you, like a creepy person. I'm not trying. Felicia, get out of my face. I'm talking about Kylie Jenner. Like, look at that. If I look like that, I'd be getting lip injections all day. Because I feel like that looks...
don't do that, because you have that kind of that...
Well, no, they wouldn't look right on my face, but I feel like she looks better.
Because you have that Japanese anime type...
Big eyes, look, little face.
Big eyes, yeah.
Yeah, I look like a deer in the headlights, but whatever. Anyway, she's smoking hot. I love the Kardashians. They're my guilty pleasure. I know they're crazy. I know, whatever. But...
Danny, you are so beautiful.
Oh, Jesus, I know, but calm down.
No, I'm just saying...
I'm not saying, oh my God, I love them because they're so beautiful because I'm ugly.
No, I know, but you're so beautiful. But you know what you have that's even more exciting and enticing than anything I've seen with them?
My humble personality?
You have brains and charisma. I mean, you really do. And that's, I mean, I'd rather hang out with you at a bro night than any one of the Kardashians.
Sounds like except we're going to have a...
Except for that cute... Except for one of their older brothers, he's kind
of
cute.
One
of the Jenner brothers. He's getting ready to do a sex thing. I'd like to be a co-host on that show. He's getting ready to do a sex show.
Okay, we are going to talk about that when we come back. Live in studio, Joe Ellen, Danger Davis, Dani Blaze. In the next hour, Dani Blaze will talk about how people fail on online dating sites. So stick around for that. We'll be back after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air. Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Now, I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service,
reasonable rates, satisfaction guaranteed,
licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
Armed Radio Global presents its new 2015 Talk at Night lineup.
Mondays, 8 p.m. Eastern, spot on with Lino and Tom.
Straight Talk with Matt Haisley. Mondays and Fridays, 10 p.m. Eastern.
On Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, 8 p.m. Eastern, followed by High Five at 10 p.m. Eastern with Johnny and Mikey.
Wednesdays on the air with Mike Allen, 10 p.m. EST. And Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Join the talk now on Ustream TV. Replays on Spreaker, exclusively on Armed Radio Global.
I want a little sugar in my bowl.
Do what?
No,
this is just for filling in because Heather's not feeling good tonight. We're not even there yet.
What I'm saying is that music now.
Enjoy the foreplay.
Do you want it to be your music?
No, I'm just asking.
No.
Oh, okay. I just didn't know what was going on with it. No, I get that.
You want to fight? You want to throw down?
I really have a lot of anger in my little computer right now. I'm loaded.
Good God, woman. I'm about ready to get some pepper spray.
You know what I want to talk about?
No. No one cares.
Well, you probably haven't seen the preview for it.
What are we doing? Hey, we didn't even talk about e24.com.
Go ahead and talk about it. You do it.
Girl. I'm going to do it. Okay, everybody, pick up your phone, which you're probably already on taking selfies or playing Words of Friends, as us cast members do. But go to your iTunes store or your Play Store and download e24.com. And put in your zip code. They will find restaurants in your area that deliver food to you, and then they will have it delivered to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants. Boom.
Booyah.
In your face. Okay, Patrick wants to talk about nerd stuff now that I'm done ranting about plastic surgery and transgenders. Go, Patrick.
It's a
bit.
First of all, Patrick, how is it being married to another man?
It's not that bad.
Dye your hair turquoise?
Who sucks whose penis?
He sucks mine. Well, no. I mean, like, it's cool because, like, he doesn't care if I, like, sleep around with other women or at least, like, try to sleep around with other women. Yeah. Well, plus he has a girlfriend, so, I mean, it's just an awkward stage for him.
In all honesty,
you son of a bitch!
I really feel like Seth would be the beta.
I do.
Right? I feel like Patrick's the alpha in that marriage.
Patrick is
the man. I thought I'd never say that, ever.
I don't see it.
No, you... When you've known Seth as long as...
The rest of us...
Yeah.
In this room, you learn...
But yeah, no... So I finally watched the trailer for Suicide Squad, and I have to say it is awesome. I was really skeptical about it because
I don't know, it doesn't look that good.
Well,
I think the saving grace is going to be Will Smith and the girl who plays
Harley Quinn. She was in
not really digging the new Joker. I think it's way over the top.
I don't like his tattoos, but that's the laugh. Sold, like when you hear his laugh and he's walking up and you can't see his face behind the lamp, and then he starts talking.
But
and I'm
they
like,
took away his scars and everything from his cheeks and everything.
Well,
and
that was just Heath Ledger's version.
No,
of the Joker.
That was everybody's.
Well, yeah,
version
but I mean,
the
hey,
Joker.
They got to do their own thing too. But like I said, I didn't like the tattoos, but the trailer overall is awesome, and I've been like. Pissing Seth off because the song in the trailer, I've been listening to the original version like all day long, and I'll randomly break out and start singing it, and he gets so pissed
off.
What
song is that?
It's called I Started a Joke by the Bee Gees.
I started a joke that started the whole world.
Hold on.
Well, the one in the...
I'm not drunk enough for this, let's keep that in mind.
Yeah, the song in the trailer is it's a remixed version because it's a woman singing it. But the trailer just looks really good. I mean, it's going to have, like, you see Ben Affleck in there for a minute. He's going to obviously be Batman.
Is he Batman in Suicide Squad?
Yeah, well, he's only going to be in a little bit.
Is this the song you're talking about?
Yes.
I
started a joke. It started the whole world crying.
This is what they played in the Suicide Squad?
Yeah, but it was a remixed version of it. It was, instead of the BG, it was a woman singing, and it was a little slower, more melancholy.
More melancholy than this? Jesus, take the wheel.
Let's see.
I started to cry. Which started
the whole world laughing. Laughing?
But no, I was just real, like, I was at work all day today, and since Seth was at the comic, or at the wedding, I had nobody to talk
to. Hold on, where was Seth at?
He was at the at that wedding that he had to go to with his
girlfriend. The Comic-Con wedding, did you say?
No, I meant to say
that's
comic,
what he said.
No, I didn't.
He blew off work and went to Comic-Con. You just outed him on the air.
No, I didn't. He went to a wedding, I almost said comic book store.
Which he probably went to before.
Yeah, this is
this
song
is the one
from the
Suicide Squad. Right?
Yeah,
already less boring.
But I mean, you've got Viola Davis; she's in it. She's the black lady that kind of orchestrates the whole thing.
Yeah, the Suicide Squad.
Yeah. Did you see Wolf of Wall Street?
Yes, I did.
You know the hot chick that's banging Leonardo DiCaprio throughout the whole movie?
Yeah.
His wife?
Yeah, that's Harley Quinn.
No. I'm watching that movie now.
You want to know what else?
I am watching that movie now.
I am older than her. I just recently found out that I'm a couple months older than that girl.
That means she's still fresh.
So that means I'm older than her.
Well, yeah. Yeah, you're like Will Smith's age.
Yeah, except Will Smith is still hot.
But Will Smith doesn't have a beard like that.
Because he has too much money to have a beard like that.
But no, yeah, the preview looks awesome.
He can't grow an exquisite beard.
I'm really upset it doesn't come out for like a year and like two, three months.
But you know what I'm excited for this Christmas?
Star Wars.
No. Although I'll go see it.
What are you excited for?
Probably my favorite superhero. See if you can guess who it is. He wears red so his bad guys can't see him bleed.
Deadpool.
But that guy over there is... Thinking ahead, he wore the brown pants. I love it.
Deadpool.
It's going to be awesome.
They released. They haven't released it yet online.
I used to be a Deadpool fanatic because the whole writing for Deadpool, everything he says during that's the whole comic book is all that snarky.
Yeah, he's always breaking the fourth wall.
Yep.
No, they released the trailer at Comic-Con and somebody uploaded it, and I'm positive it's going to be a rated R Deadpool movie.
Oh, yeah, it will.
Which it needs to be.
It has to be. You can't do Deadpool. It's going to be a hard R. It's going to be a real hard R.
The trailer alone dropped like at least three F-bombs that they showed. And it was really good.
It's like a movie of my life.
Yeah.
The F-word
except
is my
you're
favorite
not,
word.
Except you're not Ryan Reynolds.
I'm not.
Which is sad. I wish you were.
And this is just a little radio show.
I'd give you awkward side hugs.
Blake Lively.
If you were
Blake Lively, Jesus, that woman is gorgeous. Every time, you think so? I love Blake Lively, and especially in
Google.
she is hot, especially in Gossip Girl. I have seen every episode multiple times of Gossip Girl. I also love that show, but Blake Lively, even in her, what hair dye line is it? Because Lord knows she doesn't dye her hair out of a box, but I think it's Revlon. But oh my God, she has beautiful hair, and she just has these eyes, and she's so tall and.
Down,
I
Danny.
Totally fangirl over her. She's beautiful. I fell in love with her and what is?
Oh, hello.
Yeah, thank you. Right, Jesus, take
is
the
she's
wheel.
She's in Deadpool.
No.
She even looks hot.
She's married to Ryan Reynolds. Yeah,
she even looks hot, pregnant.
Well, most women get that pregnant glow.
Well, plus when women get pregnant, about the fourth month they get the porn star gene.
Not all.
The porn star hormones.
My best friend was pregnant. She didn't want to be touched the whole entire time she was pregnant.
Well, then your friend's weird.
No, yeah. It's hit and miss.
Girls, when they're pregnant, like to get bone.
Yeah, for the most part, there are women that have...
Trust me,
like Seth would know, right?
Seth doesn't like to be touched when he's pregnant.
Around and I'll be like, Sethipoo! And call him names like that.
Oh,
Yeah, God. Pretty much. But no, we were leaving work, and I said, and I can't remember what the sentence was, but I said, sweetie, and he like immediately like dropped his phone down. He was like, don't call me that. And I'm like, so what? I was like, wait, so I can call you Sethy Poo in front of your coworkers, your manager, and the people that you are waiting tables on, but you get mad when you get called sweetie. And I was talking to one of my other coworkers, and he was like, I call him sweetie all the time, and he doesn't get mad at that.
Oh, Seth.
So we're going to have a talk when we get home.
I'm telling you, Seth's getting a little strange on the side.
Yeah, it was only okay.
We totally lost you, Jolyn, with all this.
No, I've been around the block.
All right, so nerdy, you guys have to teach me about nerdy superhero stuff.
Joe, you've been a gay man.
Can I take you to the comic book store?
Yeah. Do you see that new game store that just opened?
Which one?
In Hutto, have you seen it?
No.
Oh, we stopped by today. It was awesome. They had land in there and everything. It's the old building. Yeah, it's that old building on the corner that used to be a florist.
Where though?
Downtown Hutto.
Oh, okay. I'll check.
I mean,
that
think
out.
Of downtown Hutto.
Okay, well, no, I didn't hear downtown.
Jesus Christ,
well, see,
it's one street, dude.
Even Hutto.
Yeah,
I would. Half a block.
I would.
It's not even a block.
I would totally take Dani Blaze to. Yeah, I would totally take Dani Blaze to the comic book store.
Let's do this.
Well, no, because I mean, a bunch like some of the guys that go in there have probably never seen it. Have probably never seen a woman naked. So, like, I bring you in there, and they're going to freak the hell out, and I'm going to have to be like, no.
That's the Big Bang Theory.
Yeah.
And
I'm
going to
be like,
I'm
Haley.
You're Penny.
Penny.
Haley
Cuckoo.
No, Penny. Her name is Penny.
Yes, her name is Penny, says the geek.
I'm talking about her real name, whose husband's
Why,
also hot. I also follow her on Instagram.
If you come, like, with me, though, and there's, like, a bunch of, like, nerdy people in there that I know, I'm just going to be like, yeah, I'm putting my dick in that.
I'll be so game for that. Let's do this.
Let's do this. Like, I took Alex there once, and he would just, like, look around, and sometimes, like, I mean, I don't mean to, like, bash me, but you just see guys in there just like, I wonder if that person has ever felt the gentle touch of a woman. And you're like, no, probably not. Like, I go in there sometimes, and I'm like, man, I'm one of the cool nerds. I can actually talk to women.
I bet I can go in there and make some money with my gentle touch. Just be like, hey, why spend $500 on that? Never opened first edition action figure and touch this booty.
I will let you.
Just go in there dressed as Supergirl from the new Supergirl New 52 with her getup. You'd probably, there'd be like, it'd be like Boner Central up in that place.
Just walk in there and say, I'll let you go XXOXX up down on me. And only geeks got that.
You win, sir. You win.
You can totally throw a combo and KO me. Let's do it.
Combo breaker.
We're going to go, you can totally go Mortal Kombat.
Finish him.
Finish him.
Yes!
Fatality.
Oh, man, that was a good game. Good game.
But no, speaking of other nerdy stuff.
Hey, what did I say about using sarcasm, little lady?
That you're not sure how it works?
Exactly.
They released the preview for Batman versus Superman, and it looks awesome. Have you seen it yet?
The Superman Batman?
Yeah. I gotta
say, did you see the short film on Facebook, the Superman during versus Batman, like Batman's like, I've come here to destroy, and then Superman hits him with their laser beam eyes and kills him. It's like the credits start rolling.
Yeah, what exactly is Batman's superpowers?
I have no idea.
Batman is
his parents. They get some sympathy. And he has
but Wonder Woman's in it, and she's
yeah.
not.
Yeah.
So,
okay, but no. So
Batman doesn't have superpowers.
The actual portrayal of Wonder Woman wasn't Wonder Woman. Isn't she like an Amazon woman? Mm-hmm. So isn't she like 500 feet tall?
No,
she's normal size. She has
then how is she an Amazonian woman?
She has a golden lasso and
I
know
she has a lasso of truth.
I'm aware of that.
She has her.
But isn't she
that
like,
she can
from
deflect
the
bullets?
Isn't
she's
she
an
from
Amazonian
like
princess?
Yeah. So isn't she supposed to be like 7'3"?
No.
Yeah. No. She. Yeah. Because she's an Amazonian.
But that's not in the comics. She's
yeah,
not.
She yes. is. That's like the only. That's like the
that's
only thing I have
Marvel.
that I don't.
She was not 7 foot tall on the TV show.
Well, that
because that's what I'm saying. It's not a
yeah.
Or in the comic book, she wasn't.
If she
tall.
Was, if she was, how
or
tall?
Or in the
she,
Hall of Justice.
If she was as tall as she's supposed to be, no one would think she was hot. That's why she can't be.
Yeah.
Amazonian women are like big old butch, like linebacker women, like the ones that TLC has a new show coming out. It's called My Gigantic Life, and it's all women that are like 6'7". 6'9 and stuff. That's how tall she would be. No man wants to look at that because then men feel emasculated.
Have you ever seen Game of Thrones?
Yes.
You know, okay. Brienne of Tarth? That pretty, like, her, she could have been a really good Wonder Woman because she's, like, huge and, like, not in a bad way. Just give her some long hair.
Go ahead, Joe.
Okay, so.
Get me out of this geekdom. I got geek all over me now.
No. So, you met my cute nephew last night. He's 10, right?
Yes.
He said last night, JoJo, you know what I want to do? And I go, what? And he goes, I want to do a TV show. It's going to be fictional. And I want to be Kid Batman.
Okay, this is only 6 feet.
And I said,
that's just normal.
And I'm like so glad that he clarified that it was going to be fictional because I kind of thought he was real, you know.
Yeah.
But speaking of tall women emasculating men, I was at I was organizing an event one year for SDC athletes, and Heidi Gillingham was who played for the Who are the Vols?
Tennessee
Volunteers.
She's like 6'7", right? Gorgeous. She walks and looks like a queen and plays basketball. And I want to say the guy's name is Kevin Smith. That might be wrong, but he played for Florida. Went on to play pro. He was 6'5". Sweetest kid I knew. I mean, he was this adorable, sweet guy. I mean, he was 6'5". And he goes up to her, and she's so gentle and lovely and gracious. And he goes up to her, and he says, I'll take you on. I'll take you on in basketball. I'll take you on. And she's... And it was the oddest thing, because here's this kid who's normally so groovy cool, and when he meets a woman who's taller than him, which has probably only happened once in his life, he absolutely brings out this macho thing. It was hilarious.
Men have a complex with women that are taller than them. Not all men.
I don't. You're taller than me. Well, like when you put your 6-inch stripper heels on.
Well, yeah. Well, that. I feel like men are a little bit more forgiving in that. I mean, I'm technically the average height of a man.
What's up next, Dani Blaze?
I'm talking about why you sad, pathetic people on online dating. Not that online dating is sad and pathetic, but why you guys are still sucking at it and not getting anywhere. I love online dating.
Stick around for getting in bed with Dani Blaze. Remember, you can see Joellen.
Not the way you talk to me on online dating. You're not getting in bed with me. Let me tell you what.
I tell you. Better bring a lot of
all right, Joe
Bartles and James.
And Ruflin.
Joellen sings Friday, July 17th, happy hour at Two Rivers Market. That's in Georgetown, Texas. Look them up on Facebook. She'll be singing for 2 whole hours. So we'll have to go down there and support that. But if you live in the Central Texas area and you're listening to my voice right now, head on down. You will not be disappointed. She has a great voice. We're going to go out of this break and come back with Dani Blaze right after these messages. I'm Mike Allen. This is the Armed Radio Global Network, and you are on the air.
In my defense, I said I was going to only say the F word once, and I only...
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global. Attention, world of tank gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on three servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches.
Yeah. You know what time it is. It's time to get in bed with Dani Blaze. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by E24.com. Just go. Go to iTunes or Google Play. Download that free app. Put it on your phone. And you put in a zip code. They'll find a restaurant near you that will deliver food to you. And it's like having a food truck in your pants. The views and opinions expressed by Miss Dani Blaze are hers and hers only and do not represent the views and opinions of On the Air with Mike Allen, Armed Radio Global, Studio 6 Entertainment, or Mike Allen Sports. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, she's at the end of her sentence. That's right.
It just started. I'm only day three in.
But it's called a...
Oh. I'm on my
Which
rag.
Is the end of So this should be good.
If I start crying, don't hold it against
me. I'm gonna go ahead and step outside and hope for the best.
No, I got my ranting out. It's cool. So
here she is, Miss Dani Blaze.
So Aaron came over yesterday with vodka. You know,
always a good time
to soothe my period woes after I'd been drinking tequila. So Lord knows I was already done. And I'm going to wait for you to get back to talk about that part. No, because you can chime in on the yes game.
Okay.
So, we're just watching movies, hanging out, drinking vodka, you know, whatever. So, although I am not actively trying to date people, since I found an awesome person, I have all the dating apps still for this purpose. So, I started doing this game where I give them three random words, and then I make them tell me a story. And I have discovered that between all of the dating apps and all the people that I've gotten just random words like tapestry, paper, nail clipper, somehow 98% of the stories are either a funny story or a sexual story. Mm-hmm. How you turn three random words that have nothing to do with sex or anything funny and turn that into sexual or funny, I don't know.
How much of it is sexual?
A surprising amount.
You're gonna read the stories, though, right?
I have a few I can read. Some of them are so long I cannot even deal.
Because they really want to get in bed with Dani Blaze.
I'm telling you. Okay, let's go.
Do you represent yourself as Dani Blaze on dating sites?
No. Okay, so this one. His three words were tedious, apple, and position.
Well, there you go.
Okay, those ones could be, but this one was kind of... Anyways,
I was eating an apple at work when I matched with Danielle on Tinder. I became so excited I had to set my apple down. Setting an apple down when it's half eaten is tedious. It may be unbalanced and roll onto the floor. I was excited about matching with Danielle because I assume that she is quite skilled in a variety of sexual positions that I would like to try with her. Okay.
And that's going to win every time.
Then some guys write, like, freaking novels. This one guy wrote about gum.
Really, Danny, what they're saying... Put me in cold.
I'm ready to play today. I'm trying to read one that... Because there was one that I screenshotted that had zero things to do with... I mean, even putting the words, I couldn't think of anything sexual. And this guy managed... Because that one's about Jesus... This one's funny. I'll give this guy this one. His three words were sock, grove, and war. His story was, the sock, it's just like whatever pops in my head. Okay. The sock was his best friend. It's hard to admit that now, but it was true at the time. He decorated it in different ways, but his favorite was the soldier outfit. He would send the sock to war to fight evil socks, then return home triumphant to the cheers of citizens living in Drawtown. No matter how much praise the sock received, it never made the memories of the grove go away where he lost his partner. See, that's awesome.
That is very...
Why you know what I got talking to him. And you know, I don't, and you know what that sock's parents said? Darn.
Oh.
See what I did there?
And that, folks, is Mike Allen's Tinder profile. Okay, let me... Okay, so I do this with all... No.
I can tell you about one thing that
these
the
all these guys are 25 to 40. Don't judge me.
That's my age.
Food.
Oh, well, excuse me.
40.
Okay. What the hell are you doing? Wait a minute. Time the 40.
40.
So close.
Yeah.
You're swiping right on 40s?
Yeah. Anyways, at this point, I'm not looking to date anybody off of here. I already found one. I'm going to lock him in a storage cellar. I'm keeping him. So
now this is just for fun.
Yeah, this is just solely for shit for the
just
show.
Just for CT.
So, my actual profile, you know, I got my pictures and stuff, and it says, I will give you three words. These three words have been selected at random. You must create a story using all three words. Your story can be short or long, detailed or simple. If you don't accept this challenge, don't swipe right. So, I had this guy. I showed Mike this conversation the other day. Oh, Jesus, I should not have let him play the yes game. I have got to scroll. Where's he at?
For those of you listening, the yes game is when Danny hands over her phone to myself and a gentleman named Aaron, and we just sit there Juan Pablo, and we just sit there and swipe right and say yes to everything. Now, Danny, very attractive, so everybody's picking her. So by the end of the day, we got all these random people, and we'll start conversation. We'll do the conversations like we're Danny. We've had people get hotel rooms. We had a guy shave yesterday, right?
Almost
got a shave.
He wanted me to call him, and I just didn't want to be that invested. But, I mean, he was like, yeah, I'll do it for you.
But the best thing is when we sent pictures of male genitalia
The best part was, like, right when it got sent to me, I knew who it was. And the guy that you did it, it was some random black guy. And then I texted him and I sent him like a picture of my face, and it was like a stern resting bitch face. And I was like, sorry, man. I was like, I'm sorry. You've got duped by my friend Danielle and Aaron.
The names. Oh my god.
Well, I didn't drop the names, but I was like, you got duped by my friends. This is my number, not theirs. And his response was just like, it just seemed like typical, like something that like a black guy would say in the 50s. He was just like, oh lordy, I done got played by, I can't remember. And he wouldn't stop talking to me.
That is the same thing that happened to Josh whenever we sent him.
Because we sent him the dick picture.
The guy stalked him, found him on Facebook, and added him as a friend. What on earth?
Okay. Anyway, so we're just saying, we're not sending, we didn't send dick pics.
We had guys.
To Danger Davis. We gave the guys.
Danger Davis's number.
His phone number saying, boy, I'd really like to see what I'm in for when I get to the hotel room you just bought for me. And send it to, you know, send me a picture to this number.
But the guys thought they were sending it to
Danny.
To me.
To female.
Yeah. Okay, so then I have this guy. I mean, and he just looks like he's been doing steroids for quite some time. He's not. You saw him. We read this conversation. Don't say his real name.
Albert.
So Albert, because I'm not going to use people's names because I'm not here to exploit people.
Well, plus we don't have their permission.
He is mid-30s.
Plus Albert, you know, he might be used to saying stuff like this.
I rammed a guy. I'm coming.
Yeah. Okay, so this is the conversation with Albert. Now, my profile has nothing about me or my personality. It only just says I'm playing this three-word game. So he sends me a message. Something tells me there's a lot to you. I was like, what do you mean? He goes, you are very attractive, but have a style that is yours. Just more interesting than what I'm used to here. I was like, okay, thanks. He's like, so how'd the week treat you? Oh, he's like, so did the week treat you? I was like, it did. And then I said, I'm going to give you the three words, yada, yada, yada. His three words were triangle, pine, and coupon. And he goes, I would, but I don't do much without a purpose. I said, okay. Because obviously I'm not trying to get to know you. You're not even attractive to me. Because I just say yes to everybody. So that way I feel like I can get a better,
come on,
a more well-rounded study. And he goes, I'm going to start this conversation out disappointing you. Maybe I'll come up with a story when the time is right. Get out of my face. I was just like, okay. He's like, is that it? And I said, yes. Well, I admire you having standards. They may not be ones I'm used to, but there's a reason you have them. I was like, it has nothing to do with standards. It's a social experiment. Well, I'm a grown man. Experiment on animals and guys with no self-respect. I'm not a toy. Neither are you. I would respect you more than to experiment with some three-word story. How I respond to you asking is your experiment results. You found a man who won't play the game. Log these results for future use. I said, this mother trucker is crazy. I said, dude.
He's part of your...
No, he's the guy. He's the guy that if you get in a relationship
said, dude,
with...
I said, calm your tits.
Yeah, he's the type of guy that if you got in a... He would be... as a man, he would be like a woman.
He'd want to like
know where you're at. He'd want to know who's calling you. He'd want to know, you know, what happened. And then he'd play it all off as, well, I really care about you. When he's really just very over-possessive, very low self-esteem. You can tell by, I mean, just looking at him.
Oh, Jesus, yes. Okay. So I said, dude, calm your tits. He said, I'm calm. I just wanted you to have a full report for your experiment. Now you go lay my results over other guys' reactions and build a good social database to find the perfect man. I said, it has nothing to do with finding the perfect man. It has nothing to do with dating at all. Most people find it to be an awesome icebreaker, which I've gotten a lot. People are like, oh, that's really cool. Like, you know, that's a good way, as opposed to saying, hey, that's real productive in online dating.
Yeah, I want to get with you.
I was like, and most people say it's an awesome icebreaker, and I have yet to be yelled at for it. So congrats to being that guy. He goes, and how's it working out for you? Honestly, you are still here swiping, so storyline seems to get boys who like to tell stories. I would refine my approach. So at this point, I'm just, my patience level is through the fuck.
How old is this guy?
He is 34 years old.
Come on, Albert.
Come on, Albert.
Get your shit together.
Thank you. And so I said, I just think it's cool to see how creative people are. Jesus fucking Christ. And he goes, you are so angry, and really this is probably the best way to get to know someone. Conflict resolution and how they operate when stressed. We just did better than your story. I said, whatevs. I'm going back to my stories. He goes, I don't doubt it. I still think you were cute as heck. Let me know if you're willing to be patient on my story. Maybe I'll sit across from you over a beer or coffee, and I'll tell you a story then. I said, I appreciate the offer.
Hey, Albert.
Will your mouth still remember the taste of
these nuts?
I was like, well, I appreciate the offer, but no, thank you. He goes, I figured it would be a good fresh start. I said, you're crazy. And then we have not talked since. But, so now back to the yes games. Now that you're here, because you can be the voice for Aaron, since Aaron's not here with us right now. So Aaron plays a yes game. He was talking to the guys on there, off of my profiles. Aaron... And we all know Aaron's not a man of many words, but he's got some good stuff built up. Aaron was like, I don't even know what to say. It's the saddest thing I have ever seen. He's like, is it really like this all the time, like when you're trying to online date as a woman? I said, yes. Now, I can't vouch for all women, but for attractive women, I can only assume it's all the same. So we'll get back to that after this break. Why men are... very unsuccessful with
total like train wreck just
with attractive ladies on the internet. And why Tony sucks. I mean, Albert sucks. Whatever.
Damn it!
Damn it, Albert!
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Hi, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat, right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry, many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today.
At 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. Online 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global. Attention, World of Tank gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on three servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches.
FaceTiming, so I can't do my segment. Oh, welcome back, guys. We're going to talk about... Oh, brought to you by E24.com. Go to your iTunes store or your Google Play store and download the E24.com app. It's free. And then you put in your zip code. They will find places in your area that deliver food to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants.
Boom. In your pants.
In your pants. In my bed. Or something. I don't know. I tried to tie that into my segment. It didn't work out very successfully. So, back to online dating as a woman.
What about as a man? Struggles.
Well, I can tell you my experience with Tinder.
Oh.
I'm one for about 300.
Apparently.
And the one that I went to the ranch and met with told me that she biked and worked out and was very active.
She lied.
And she basically was as big as me.
No, apparently, no shit. Apparently,
but I don't lie about it.
No.
I put my pictures up there of what I look like. I don't take headshots from above, so my double chin goes away.
You don't have a double chin.
I don't. Look, here's some signs that the woman on the profile.
We did this last week.
Yeah,
we did.
Is a biggin.
We've done all this.
We got wolf pictures of dogs.
Not nothing to do with what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, wolf pictures. Pictures of dogs.
So I was like, let me delete all the wolf pictures.
And then when they do, it's only a headshot and it's from above.
From the 80s.
Or back when they were hot.
This is the headshot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotta show more.
Talk about Mad Mike real quick and his Tinder exploits.
Oh, go ahead.
So apparently, since Mad Mike has broken up with his girlfriend.
He had sex with somebody in an alleyway.
No, he was bragging to Seth about how he has slept with about 55 women from Tinder. And I looked at Seth and I was like, oh, well. Okay, I made that joke. But I was like, come on. I was like, it's like quality over quantity.
Amen.
Like, it's like, I feel like we're going to have to do an intervention for Davis and be like, yo, Davis, quit putting your penis in every girl you swipe right with. Quit swiping with your penis.
And it's not like the super hot girls on there. It's because like
I'm telling you, you're going to put your sin stick in one of the devil's, you're going to start ringing the devil's doorbell with your sin stick, and then you're going to wake up the next day, and you're not going to have a sin stick.
Well, I mean, as he refers to them as dog bags.
Wait, he refers to vaginas as doggy bags?
No, he calls condoms dog bags.
Oh, well, he's an idiot.
Anyway, so Aaron, being a very alpha, normal man, saw what dating is like through my profile, and he was so
taken aback.
So sad and so taken aback. He goes, I can't believe this is what it's really like. Because for the most part, and I do online dating, and I don't think I'm sad or anything, but a lot of people that do online dating are not the most confident people or whatever, because it's a lot easier to get rejected when you're not face-to-face with somebody. And I'm pretty sure I talked about that before, too. But, I mean, some of the messages I get are like, come sit on my face, or when can I stuff your muffin with my jelly filling? But then, on the flip side of that, I get messages as in, oh my goodness, can you please respond to me? You're the prettiest girl I've seen on here. Like, I can't even... Like, you have to, like, it's just total desperation. Either way, because I'm just like, no, thank you.
Huge turn off.
Absolutely. It's not, and the guys are like, oh my gosh, you're so beautiful. Like, I've never seen anything. Like, I can, you're.
Let me pull up some of mine.
That's probably better than the, hey, come sit on my face, or hey.
Pull up some of mine, but don't do matches with me.
Anyway, I have a. So I got matched with this one chick. I don't think I have it on here anymore.
About you, Patrick.
Well, no, it just reminded me because you said the sit on my face thing. I messaged her. She matched with me, and she was like, hey, what's up? And I'm like, not much. I was like, I'm just at work right now, bartending. I was like, what are you doing? She's like, I'm currently in your apartment removing all of your chairs and stuff. And I was like, why? And she's like, that way when you come home, the only thing you have to... the only thing I have to sit on is your face. And I was like,
and see, as a woman, you know, I was saying shit like that, so, you know, it's a catch-22, but...
You didn't like that?
I get very tubby.
Not really.
Okay, so one that I got was, this is what his thing says.
We're not tubby, we're aerodynamically challenged.
This guy's double chin's bigger than my boobs. He was nice, or whatever. So, he says, I'm a 32-year-old single guy looking to meet someone amazing. I like Doctor Who, Star Wars, Star Trek, and most things nerdy. I'm searching for someone to hang out with, tired of being the third or fourth or fifth wheel with all my friends. And I was like, that makes you come off so desperate. Like, why throw that in there? Like, because it makes you, this is what I just read. This is what, when I read stuff like that, this is what I see. Oh my goodness. I still live in my mom's basement. Can you please touch my penis so I know what it's like before I die? And that's a very extreme version of what he said. You know, whatever, be nerdy, that's fine.
My profile gets me. You want me to read what my profile says on Tinder?
Read it into the mic?
Okay. So, and I want to say the beard also helps because when I made the stupid
mistake... So why did you shave it off, you woman?
Because it's just so much fun to grow it back.
He likes being slapped in the face by Alex.
Yeah, well, we can't now because I have it back. But yeah, there was the dry spell where nobody wanted to talk to me because I didn't have a beard. But yeah, this is are we playing the soundboard?
No, I think what you just
so
said.
This is
is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard.
It works.
Everyone in this room.
So it says
is now dumb for having listened.
No. Well,
may God have mercy.
I'm plugged into my phone. My bad.
Soundboard.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm plugged into my own phone.
That's comedy. Whoops.
It is.
It's annoying. It's the same ones every week.
My bad.
I know. I got to get some new ones.
All right. So it says, I read comic books daily. I love being outdoors, but I won't say no to sitting around and binge watching Game of Thrones.
Oh, wait. That's you?
That's me. I have a cat. I have a paragraph about my cat. It says, I have a cat. His name is Nostromo. He's named after an M-class star freighter. That's pretty cool. Also, speaking of cats, I suffer from obsessive cat disorder, also known as OCD. Stop. I'm really simple to get along with. I like beer and music and everything about Austin. Just shoot me a message and let's get the ball rolling.
Stop.
Ask me about my traffic cone.
Stop.
I'm a bartender in the real world.
Okay, so.
Stop. Can I get dates?
Stop.
Would, okay,
stop.
Would you
stop.
Like
hold
to
on.
Get more dates?
Hold on, hold
what,
on.
Are you going to write my about me?
No.
Hold on.
In order to
hold,
get
hold on, Danny,
more
I got
dates.
A question.
No, because I don't ever get to actually
got,
talk during
I got
this
because
you just say stupid shit and play soundboards.
I'm not playing stupid shit.
So,
I got a legitimate question.
In order to get laid more, delete the first two paragraphs about your bullshit comics and the I love being outdoors. Okay, that's like girls saying I like
but
hiking.
Here's the thing. Do you get laid off that?
Yes.
I do.
He does.
Okay, here's mine. Here's mine. And
in order to get laid more, I'm going to fix one person at a time. I can't fix you both at the same time. In order
no,
to
let me get, listen to his real quick.
In order to get laid more, just delete the first two paragraphs.
But I like the shit about my cat.
Who gives a shit? No one gives a shit about your cat.
Okay,
if you just want to get your right, dick, right. If you just want to get your dick wet, no one cares
well,
about your personality. Just get out of my face. Your husband would be so mad. All
right.
Okay.
I'm in entertainment. I have an active lifestyle, and I do. I get out. We do stuff.
Like what? You didn't want to get up today to mow the lawn. Get that fuck out of my face. So you're doing the same shit that women do to you, and now you're mad about it.
It's an active way. I'm always going places. I got
where?
Entertainment.
What? Where are you going?
I go
where
ringing outs. You drag me out. We go to bars
okay,
and stuff.
You,
I go
okay,
downtown.
When I hear active lifestyle, I think.
Okay, shut up. I don't need drama.
Camping.
All right, let's
I don't
here.
Need distractions. I'd like a friend that we'll enjoy life with. Open to adventures. No, I'm not right. going to an age verification and entering my credit card information to prove that I'm real. No, I don't want to sign up to a website to see your pics because you're so shy. In the end, I'll buy you tacos and touch your butt.
Okay. I'm going to tell you what's wrong right there.
I don't even know where to start.
One, you don't live an active lifestyle.
I do. Who gets up first every morning?
That is not
and
active.
Then you sit on your computer, watch Netflix while gaming.
That's active.
No.
No.
So you're,
hey,
you're
I've gotten
saying,
four battleships
okay.
to
no.
tier four.
So you're
in
saying
2 days.
Shit that no. girl, like that girl said. You know, you were mad because she said
okay,
she rides
saying,
books and
here.
Does outdoor stuff, and then she was.
Of the
side.
Girls who've written me back.
I'm not done fixing you yet. Let me fix you first.
There's no fixing me.
No, but I can fix your profile.
Can I just have you type mine up?
Autumn types me, "Hi, cutie pie." I said, "Hey there, sorry about the delay. It was November 21st, and I wrote her back January 8th.
Okay, so you can't be mad that you're not getting laid. Boom. Okay. So problem number four.
Okay. Aaron, who says she likes the Detroit Lions, I said, "Go Lions," and nothing. Dementria.
You mean dementia? Let's go on.
Merry Christmas, Feliz Navidad. Is your house filled with family like mine? No, not this year. Are you alone? Yes, but with roomies and pets. No family this year. My son is having a daughter stop by for turkey. Blah blah blah. How about take your lunch sometime? Smiley face. Here's my cell. Shoot me a text and we'll get together. Merry Christmas, Mike. I'll do that. Nothing.
Okay.
Actually, I think
hold on.
You and I met on Tinder.
No, it was good. You just need to write the first two.
No,
okay.
You and I met on Tinder.
I don't have you.
Oh
any.
My gosh.
You, no one ever.
Oh my gosh.
I never.
I bet money we met on Tinder. And you sent me your text. You sent me your thing and said.
You're not on here. I don't erase none of them.
Okay, that's because I'm going to reactivate my account right now. We'll find out. I need the mic.
Okay.
Oh, and Diane. And Diane says, we went back and forth for a while. Hi, Mike. How you doing? Like your hairs, the pictures. She says, damn, I have to run. Can you add me here? tindwebcomconnect.com.
Because obviously,
and of course, you hit it, and it's like, hey, for a month, you pay this and that. And I said,
okay.
I'm telling you, we've met on Tinder.
So, the one, you don't live a natural lifestyle. Two, stop putting bitter old man shit about bots on there. Everyone runs into bots. I run into bots. People think I'm a bot. Bots are part of the internet. We should all stop dating on the internet if we don't want to deal with bots.
What's a bot?
Some really like, seductively hot woman that is actually a man.
Oh, I've had whole conversations on here with bots. It's awesome.
Ooh, can I talk about...
They want to send you money.
So... The opposite of the, oh my God, I'm tired of being the fifth wheel and the third wheel and yada yada, is the asshole that's so bitter about online dating and bots that it's just like, I don't want to talk to this guy because he just, you come off like a dick, like straight out the gate, so no one's going to want to talk to you.
But I am a dick.
Okay, and that's why you and me are going to die alone in this house, but that's not what I have to, that's not what
No, you're out here in May, don't even tell me that
shit. Yeah, I will be out of Texas.
I will be alone in this house.
I just want to. I want
to
share one of
then
my.
I'm talking about
what it's like to date as a woman on the internet. If you guys interrupt me one more time, I'm going
to
snap.
Then I'm going
to
have.
I will give you guys your break.
You're going
to
move
talk out after this commercial break. Joellen, we'll have to talk about Mike on there in a second. I just want to say, stop coming off like a dick. I don't care if you think you're high and mighty. That's shitty. You're not going to meet anybody. And then on the other hand, don't come off as a sad, pathetic guy. If you're sad and pathetic, you're not going to get anywhere on dating, and you're not damn sure going to get a girl that looks like me. And I'm not saying that to be mean, but someone needs to hear the truth. Someone needs to stop pitying these people. You need to know what you look like, and you need to accept that. And then you need to date someone within your means. Go, Joellen.
Mike, I'm telling you, we tendered.
Did we?
I know we did, because you sent... I'm pretty sure you did, because you sent me your phone number and said, call me sometime, and I don't call men or boys.
Well, how the hell am I supposed to call you if I don't know your number?
You could have... You didn't could have asked for my number.
Yeah, but then people get upset about that.
Well,
see, here's the problem with women. One, they don't know what the hell they want.
I do.
Two,
I know exactly what I want.
Hey, I know what I want.
I can't. I'm telling you. I know. As soon as you said, "Here's my number. Give me a call," I remember it. It came to me like a flash, which is insane. I know.
Okay.
You never call me though. I know. I don't call men. Go look.
You activated your account?
I just activated my
account. That's not going to bring it up once you deactivated it.
No.
Are you sure?
It won't bring it up.
Unload or uninstall the app and then reinstall the
Usually we have a pretty good conversation until I say, how about coffee or lunch? And then it's like nothing after that.
I just eliminated it from my phone.
Okay, so
I
didn't, if you re-download it, it should pop up everything that you have.
Okay, but I can't figure out how to get on it.
I can give you a rundown real quick of how to be smart and sexy with a girl and get her to sleep with you, apparently.
Can I
tell my Tinder story?
Well, yeah, go ahead and tell your Tinder story.
Because this chick was like really hot, and I don't know how I used Pokemon to pull this off. Oh, you got to go into settings, privacy, location, and switch Tinder on. It's under your settings. Oh, he misses us. Yay! So this is this girl.
Who misses us?
Oh, no, this is one of our friends that we met up in Lubbock. We're going to just call this girl...
Priscilla.
Abigail. We're going to call this girl Abigail. Okay. So she met... And I'm going to show you what she looks like. That's her.
Okay.
That's her. She's a hottie. She's a school teacher.
So you swiped right on me then?
She started the conversation. And it was in the morning too. So of course I had a boner. So I was just being the weird... horny dude, but apparently it paid off. So she goes, are you really a bartender? I was like, yeah, why do you ask? She's like, that's awesome, I'm a teacher, so I know many of you guys, lol jk. And for some reason, since she said she was a teacher, I thought I would
Catholic school girl.
No. I would play the card that everybody plays, and I'm like, well, you're a very attractive teacher, so I'd love to know more about you. I could give you my oral report for sure. Just kidding. And she's like, ha ha ha. Oh really? Winky face. Funny. And I said, I'm a funny guy, and it was more of 30% kidding, 70% sit on my face. But enough about that. Tell me more about you. And then. She was like, I wish
I could... This gets you laid?
This is, yeah, dude, just wait. I bring up Pokemon
I'm uninstalling this.
She goes, I wish I could come up with some awesome sexual sarcastic joke back, but usually when people flirt with me, I get awkward and just blush. Well, I'm a teacher on summer break, and I like to drink, obviously, and I like to run and do yoga. And I was like, so I take it you're very flexible then. I was like, I like being outdoors
this
and I can manage.
This got you late.
So, one, she was specifically looking for sexy time. And it's, it's women like that that ruin it for other women that are not like, hey.
No, it doesn't. Women like... Women like that.
You're mad because you
I need to run into it. And look at this guy.
But look at you.
What? I'm an attractive dude.
That your face is awesome. From like your neck down is just not as good as it could be, and you know that. That's why you're doing that damn smoothie bullshit, and I'm so supportive of that. But I have told you time and time again, you cannot be out of shape and expect to date someone that is rock hard and in shape. You're thin.
Oh, okay.
No one's gonna suffocate.
Let me get to the
no
best
one's
part.
Gonna suffocate.
I'll get
that.
To the best part. Okay. Get to the best part.
Because Pokemon is involved in
this.
Okay,
skip to the
Pokemon.
No,
okay, okay. So I go.
You got laid off for Pokemon.
Just wait.
Reference.
I said.
She needs help, and she's teaching young children.
I said. I don't usually start making sexual moves. But you didn't seem to mind. I'll have to let you know that I'm a gentleman, and if you want any such sexual favors done to you, you have to take me to dinner first. I may want you to sit on my face, but I'm a nice guy, blah, blah, blah. And then we talked about reading.
Yeah.
Okay. When I said that, she goes, if you play your cards right, I could do more than just that. We'll see. And I said, I was like, I played Pokemon as a child, so I'm pretty confident that I can play my cards right. And she said, I used to play Pokemon. Those were the days. Here's my phone number. And I got her phone number.
I'm officially signing off.
And I
from
said,
the internet.
Look at that. I got
all
a girl's
Tinder
phone
apps.
Number.
There's nothing in there.
No, I want to see your profile. I want to see if you're the same person that I didn't call.
Joellen didn't even call me.
I didn't call you because I don't call men. I never
She's a high class lady. She's not a Tinder lady. She's a nice lady. She's not. I'm mad because this lady that he had sex with is teaching children.
And she's hot.
I've slept with like a
couple of teachers. She looks like she has some issues, but we're not going to talk about that.
I've slept with a couple of teachers.
But most, for me specifically, in my online dating, I have met awesome people. But for the most part, it is very sad. And I don't have
that time. Might not help either. That's one of my pictures.
Yeah,
no, the thing that I stare at first is that your tie's off-centered, but we're not going to talk about that because you need tie clip. That's another thing. Do not, so help me God, have a picture of you in a suit trying to be all fancy and you don't even have a properly fitting suit because that's an absolute denial right
but
there.
But the suit
no,
that
I'm not
wearing...
No, I'm not saying you. No, your suit, I helped okay. you, so your all suit right. fits fine
yeah.
because I know what I was doing.
Okay.
A year ago, a different picture, right?
No, same pictures.
Okay, maybe it wasn't you. But I'm telling you, it's a guy with a beard, kind of like yours, and the same body type.
Guys, do not be bitter on your Tinder about me or your any dating site about me. Don't be all like...
I even have a... Trust me, I have a beard.
Okay, you're too old to be posting cheesy shit. You are supposed to be sophisticated, but grown...
Why am I not getting...
Probably because you got
yeah.
the ladies next to you and they're like,
whoa. Crop the women out and that might help you. Patrick needs to stop talking about cats and he'll get laid even more than he's already getting laid. You need to crop all the bitches in bikinis out of your pictures. Hello. Another issue with online dating is that... See, I think my... Although I'm not dating anymore...
Oh, shit, we're late.
Oh. Are we commercial breaking?
We got to pay the bills.
Okay, commercial break.
Commercial break!
Are you ready to take your webpage to the next level? Go to icegram.com and download for free all the tools you will need to enhance your webpage content for potential customers, clients, or fans. Capture leads, call your audience to action, skyrocket conversation and engagement with action bars, pop-ups, toast notifications, message boxes, overlays, and sidebars. Head on over to icegram.com for your free download. That's icegram.com. Bottom line, you'll love it.
Hi,
Hey, now I know you hear Joe Rocks on their weekly restaurant reviews on Night Talk, 10 p.m. Eastern. And boy, these two like to eat. Right, boys? Well, here's something to review right from your house. Eat24. That's right, eat24.com. With over 25,000 restaurants for you to choose from when you're hungry. Many in your area. So review that, boys. Eat24.com. Click, order, and eat. Eat24.com.
Is your wife wicked hot, or is she just cold?
Do you just want to take a hot shower?
Call Savino Mechanical for all your heating, hot water, and cooling needs. Savino Mechanical has been servicing Greater Boston and Southern New Hampshire for over a quarter century.
Quality 24-hour service.
Reasonable rates. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Licensed and insured.
And remember, at Savino Mechanical, we are not comfortable until you are. Call Savino Mechanical today
at 1-855-624-4280.
That's 1-855-624-4280. Savino Mechanical.
Route 106 Motors is the home of fine pre-owned vehicles. Experience a no-pressure sale with a family-friendly atmosphere. Route 106 Motors has been practicing the same simple philosophy of low prices for over a decade, and it has brought us great success. Recently, while other dealers are closing their doors, Route 106 Motors is expanding. We are a wholesale dealer, and we own the property and pay cash for all the vehicles. This allows us to sell to the consumer for a lot less than the average dealership. We are a high-volume, small-profit dealer, and we pass the savings on to you. New changes have been made at Route 106 Motors. Stop by and check out our brand-new building. Route 106 Motors, located at 569 West Street. Check our website at Route106Motors.com and be sure to like us on Facebook to find out about all the latest deals and savings opportunities. Route106Motors.com.
Night Talk with Joe Rocks. 10 p.m. Eastern, Thursdays, is now on Ustream TV. Spreaker for replays and live. On Live 365 exclusively on Armed Radio Global. Attention, World of Tank gamers. Armed and its affiliated divisions are recruiting entire clans and tankers. Armed, the largest and most progressive gaming community on the World of Tanks gaming platform. Now on three servers. To join, visit www.armedtanks.net or hashtag need a toaster. Toast that, bitches.
Welcome back. The show is brought to you by e24.com. Download on your iTunes or Google Play Store. Put in your zip code. They're a fine place to deliver to you. It's like having a food truck in your pants. Boom, we're running out of time, so I got to talk fast on that. They're awesome. They deliver food everywhere. You don't have to go anywhere.
Cool.
So, like we were just talking about on the commercial break, I had a guy send me 20-some odd messages without my response.
Oh.
That is what I would call a stalker. That is, online harassment, for lack of a better term. You don't just constant, what are you doing? Hey, I have tickets to this concert. You want to go? Hey, I have this. Hey, let's go have dinner. I mean, I get that all the time, too. And I'm like, if a person has not responded to you, like when I was actively hunting my prey. I would send a message, because most guys, I'm like, I'm not going to sit here and wait on you. I see what I want. I want it. So I'll send a message. Maybe two messages. After that, I'm not talking to you anymore, because you obviously have no interest in conversing with me back. So advice out there to not being stuck to the internet for the rest of your life, if you would actually like to have a genuine relationship, is to not send 500 freaking messages to someone that's not talking to you, because now you seem crazy. And you might actually be crazy. And not, that was, this same person found me on two different dating sites.
Oh, wow.
So it's more than 20 something.
So he's really after you.
So now he's blocked, but that is, it's just, it's the saddest thing. It's like, within a few moments of talking with somebody, you should be able to determine.
stop posting needy, I'm so sad of being tired and lonely and girls are mean posts and you're about me. Stop posting I live an active lifestyle when I don't. Stop posting bitter stuff. And then don't say needy stuff. And if a girl has not responded to you, then I'd give it a max 3 messages that are spaced out. Not, hey, like 2 hours later, what's up? You know, like, hey, and then like a couple days later, you know, hey, what are you doing? Okay, I can understand that. But don't ever do more than 3, because now you're like borderline, I need a restraining order.
They've moved on.
They don't want to talk to you.
Yeah, that's kind of where.
Also, you need to understand, I had an argument, oh my God, what was that guy's name? I had an argument with this guy. So I was doing my 3-word game, right? Apparently this guy has recently gotten out of a relationship, and I told him I'm just here to do the 3-quarter stories. You know, we can probably chit-chat a little bit after that, but I'm not looking for anything at all. And, oh God, I hope I can find him. What was his name? Oh, and also don't send shit like, wow, you are so pretty, I'm at a loss. I'm in lost of words. One that doesn't even make sense. where was this guy? Anyway, so I do my 3-word story. I was like, nope, like I'm just here for, you know, the stories and radio show, and other than that, I don't want to talk. So he yelled at me and said that was really messed up because I was wasting people's time. And I said, no, one, I'm not wasting people's time because my about me specifically says I'm only here for the 3-word story. And then he said he was looking for someone to make the transition into being single easier. And I said, I think it's shittier that you are online dating when you're not ready for a relationship because you're still pissed off at your ex, because you're going to get people involved and they're going to get their feelings hurt, and that's not fair to somebody, as to where you can get the fuck over it like a real man by yourself and then go online dating. So don't yell at me about my 3-word story when I am specifically saying I'm only here for this specific purpose, I don't want to date you, and then turn that around on me and make me the bad guy. And then he turned around and said, the next day he was like, I'm sorry I offended you, I'd really like to take you out. You've, like, what do guys read that I said, I think you're being shitty because you're not dealing with this like an adult and now you're involving other people?
Men. That's one of the things I love about
that they're shitty? No. Or that they're stupid?
No, that they keep coming back.
Microphone.
I don't have a microphone.
Don't knock beers over.
I love that about men. I love that they keep coming back for more, even when you say, no way.
Get lost.
No way.
I don't like that needy bullshit.
Well, I don't necessarily think that's needy. I mean, I think that's sometimes it's needy, but sometimes it's just a little bit, you know, it's just saying, hey, look, I've got huevos. I can handle you.
No, it's fine. I can understand, but there's a difference between...
Microphone!
There's a difference between having huevos and being like, look, little lady, I want to get to know you, I'm taking you on a hot date, and you're going to like it, kind of deal. Because that's hot. But not 28 messages back to back with me not talking back to you or yelling at me because you're sad over your ex.
My Tinder won't work.
So mine did that for a while, but I think I overused mine.
Well, I haven't used mine at all. And I have no matches.
Saying locating for people. You may have to uninstall it, reinstall it, because usually it says trying to find people.
It says discover new people. I have no matches yet. Mike, all of those stories you just told about those women, you did the same thing you did with me, in theory, if you actually connected to me.
Oh,
and that is, you didn't ask them anything about themselves. There's a difference between being needy, like, will you come see me, and saying, tell me about yourself. What are your, you know, how long have you been in Austin? You know, do you have a cat? I don't know. You know.
I don't have cats.
Is by the end of this week, I will have a storm cellar built in the backyard, and I'm locking Alan in there. Then I'm not letting him go, because I honestly,
when you find a good one, trap them. You just lock them.
Lock them down.
You handcuff them you chain them to the couch, and you don't let them go, because it is rough out there to find someone that's, one, not annoying, and two, that you actually have chemistry with, because everyone's phony or stupid, mostly stupid. There's just too many stupid people out there, and I'm not made to date. I don't even know how I've been, like, half successful in my life, because I'm just, like, really bad at it. I'm mean, and I don't want to talk to you most of the time. I'm just like, yeah, cool, whatever. Adios. Oh, I'm reading the thing. Dang it, Aaron posts the best things. But, I mean, the fact that a man was on my dating stuff and he was like, I just can't believe this is what women actually have to deal with. Like, don't be pathetic. Women don't want... Actually, I don't care about anything about you until after we're already dating. When we're in the steps of dating, I just want to talk about myself. And I want you to compliment me. So, ask about...
That's Princess Dani. What Princess Dani wants, Princess Dani gets.
When you go on a date, I don't want to hear about you.
Most strong women are going to be the same thing. I mean, a woman is going to... You know, a strong kind of... healthy woman is going to feel the same way if you're not interested in her.
But that requires listening and actually being able to recall what she said.
No, yeah. You can't do that. Just keep asking questions and telling her she's pretty.
Ask questions, compliment.
But what if there's a test afterwards?
Trust me, there'll be a test. And it's not open book.
It's oral.
And most of it's shit I don't remember saying. What I actually...
Okay, so I've reloaded the Tinder app. The only person I can swipe is myself.
Well, that's Jesus' way of saying love yourself.
I do.
Check. You better check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Okay.
So stop posting bitter shit. Don't yell at somebody because you're still mad at your ex. And ask a lot of questions about them in a not creepy way, like, what's your address in? What's your license plate number in?
What time are you home alone with nobody else around?
Yeah, when do you start and stop your period? And also another thing I never noticed about online dating is that boys that I come across on the online dating world. I mean, if I said right this immediate, it's like, I had a guy almost shave his whole entire face yesterday for me to sit on it. And that's the only reason it didn't happen is because he's like, hey, give me a call real quick. I'll give you my address, because I think he thought it... Because he was like, I feel like this is fake. If I would have called him...
He's a smart guy.
But the fact that he was willing to change his appearance, Danger Davis...
Just for a woman.
To not even... I didn't even say have sex with me. For me to sit on her face...
Danger Davis.
I actually have a good question.
What is your question, Joanne?
Well, talking about changing your appearance for a woman, and we've talked about weight issues, etc., would you be willing to change your appearance for a woman?
You need to change your appearance for your health.
Well, you need to change it for your health.
That's my focus right now.
Obviously.
As far as like shaving my beard or...
If you met the woman that was really like hot, would you be willing to change your appearance for?
Like what?
Weight.
I'm already trying to lose weight. I'm doing that without a woman. But Pick something else.
No, that's a good question, though. Would you get really very vigorous in that attempt?
Would anybody? I actually know somebody that actually dropped almost 120 pounds for the person to pillow.
I mean, do you understand what I'm saying?
Well, I'm losing weight anyway, so it doesn't...
avoiding the question.
What? That's not a change. That's just a health thing.
No.
If somebody met me and comes up and says, you know what, I love you and I really want to be with you, but you need to lose 70 pounds, I look at her and go, well, I'm losing 70 pounds anyway. No. So, okay,
Let's say you thought.
Ask the question differently because he's not answering.
Okay, so you went to, let's say you go to the doctor today and the doctor says you are in pristine health, your cholesterol is perfect, your heart is in excellent condition, everything about you is completely healthy. You met a woman. Shortly after that, and she said, I want you to lose 70 pounds. Would you do it just because she wanted you to, nothing to do with your wants and your health needs?
From past experience, no. Because right after that's done, she'll pick something else. And then it becomes a control issue, and that control issue then becomes a weapon. And the weapon becomes, I'll be miserable.
My opinion on that is that...
Now, if somebody says, I really love you and I'd like to see you in better shape because I want you around me.
Let's do this together
and I'll help you. Okay. But if somebody just says, for example, if a girl comes up and says, you know, you're really attractive, but, you know, I'm just not into beards. Shave your beard for me. Okay, I shave the beard. We'll do this for me. We'll do that. Then it's just going to be one trip, fall, domino of every little thing she can come up with to prove my love. I don't prove my love to anybody. If and you I, love me and I love you, then that's it. There's no proof. Now I we're honestly, friends. Now we spend time together and we build the trust and the relationship. But there should never be, what happens is couples get into a relationship and then it becomes a never-ending quest of trying to outdo each other and proving each other's love.
There's a difference between asking someone. There's a difference between asking someone to. No. There's a difference between asking someone to prove your love and just the fact that you don't even show. You need to understand that how you feel like you're loving someone is not the same as the way that they feel like they should be loved. And I have read a thing, and I actually saw it at a random store, said, don't be mad at somebody because they're not loving you the way that you think that you should be shown love or some bullshit like that. It made sense. Mm-hmm. But stop being bitter, like, I have to prove my... You need to do stuff for women. Women need that. So if you want a successful relationship, both parties need to actively do things. It's not a pissing contest who loves who more. It's a relationship that actually works. So no, you can't just sit there and be like, hey, I'm not going to talk to you all day, and I'm not going to do the small stuff. You should want to do that in a relationship. It shouldn't have to be they have to ask you for it. You should willingly be like, hey, I'm going to send you a text to be like, hey, I hope you're having a great day. It's work. So stop with the, it's a pissing contest to see who loves each other more, because that's just partially true. Yes, I'll give you that. But at the same time, like, let that shit go. You're going to have to do some shit that you don't want to do for a woman. Women are fucking needy. We need love and affection, and we need small shit done for us. And if you do that, and it's the right person, then there's not going to be a question if you love somebody. But when you don't show anybody anything, and you're too busy bitching about the woman that you dated before her, yeah, she's going to be like, hey, I'm going to need some extra fucking work done. Because it's very hard for a woman to sit there and listen to everything any woman has ever done to you, ever in your life, and not be like, well, hell, do you even fucking love me? Why am I even fucking here? Because you seem pretty pissed off about that shit still. So, I mean, there's a fine balance between
this conversation usually begins after a huffing and puffing and eye rolling in the middle of a football game. So, yeah, I'm going to be a little mad. It's like, can you see I'm watching football?
Okay, can you see that obviously I'm reaching out to you in a very ineffective way to tell you that I'm not getting what I need out of this relationship. Now, women... Okay,
reach out to me at 6 p.m. when the game's over.
Okay, that's shitty. That is why...
Or 2 hours before the game. But don't wait until the game and then do it. Because that's planned. That's just planned.
So I've been looking at, like, cat pictures on the internet. When did shit get real?
No, my issue is that... Fine, yes. Shut up. You need your man time. That's great. You have your thing. Lord knows I'm totally fine with you having your own life. But... women have a really shitty way.
I'm fine with you having your own life. When you're in my life, I'm the princess. That's how that works.
That's pretty much.
Women have a really shitty way of coming about their needs and their wants.
Because it becomes vindictive and
no, snarky. It's not. It's fucking not. We have had this conversation in plenty of fucking time.
We have.
You have a really, really, really...
I'm jaded.
Really, yeah, and you know what? You're not going to ever, and I've told you this, you're not going to have a happy relationship until you get the fuck over it. And you know that.
I get over the last one, but then it shows up in the
next
one.
But you're not, okay, then you're not over it, and you know that, but we're going to talk about that after the show. My thing is, women, you need to learn that men can't read your mind, so you need to say, hey, this is specifically what I'm mad about, this is why I'm mad about it, then have a constructive conversation of how to either get in agreement with that situation or agree to disagree, because you're not going to fucking agree on everything. But yelling and screaming and being passive aggressive isn't going to get anything done. Open your big girl mouth, tell them what the fuck is wrong, and then your problems will be solved. But men, on the other hand, you also need to realize women are emotional. Most of the shit that goes on in a relationship is made up in our head. You need to know that a relationship is work, but you need to show love. Women accept love in a different way. If I make you a sandwich and suck your dick twice a week, you're like, oh, man, this girl's kind of, you know, into me.
Awesome.
You know, awesome. Yeah. Women don't fucking think like that. One, sex for women is mostly mental and emotional. It's not all the physical as men. Two,
but you better know what you're doing.
You telling me I'm pretty once a week, great. You should be telling me that every day because, hello, you know, I'm tired of hearing it from myself every day. And that's in, like, a joking manner, but women and men look at love and look at relationships two different ways. And both parties need to understand that.
both parties need to understand that a man is not going to be emotional and expressive and cry when he gets his man period. And men need to understand that when a woman gets her time of the month, she possibly will be in a state of psychosis for a couple of days. I cried the other day for no reason a couple times. Okay, I don't want to talk about it, but it happened. I wanted to be left alone and eat icing out of a thing.
All right. Well,
We're ending every on a woman high note. Is crazy in their own way. There's no fucking way you can't tell me that you
do not get emotional.
Oh,
it's not worth talking about. I will talk about it all day. I get fair warning.
Thank you to Kathy Glass, Rebecca Paddock, Rob Kenny, and Matt Hazley for stopping by in the first part of the show.
Thank you to
Joe Allen for sitting here with the young kids with me and tipping over the bucket of reels. Danger Davis for trying to stay out of the line of fire and finally accepting his sexuality as a man and a husband to his husband. And Danny, who, well, is a little emotional right now, and we're probably all going to die. All right, next week, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, right here on Armed Radio Global. Don't forget about Matt's show, Mondays and Fridays, 9 p.m. Central Standard. Right before his show, Leno, Spot On with Leno, comes on at 7. Tuesdays, Talk Time with Val, and then Thursdays, Night Talk with Joe Rocks. Pretty much every night of the week, you have great talk time entertainment at Armed Radio Global. For Joe Allen, Danger Davis, Danny Blaze, I'm Mike Allen. You're listening to the Armed Radio Global Network, and you have been on the air. We'll see you next week.